Come on, everybody, get set, let's go. It's the next episode. It's the Premium Pete Show. News, interviews, all of the info. Listen up, it's the Premium Pete Show. If you want the scoop and the low, down low, listen to the show, cause Milk said so. Fuck what you heard, better act like you know. Miss Listen, no, it's the Premium Pete Show.
Get smacked silly, fucking with these niggas from the What You Gonna Do. When you ready, shit, I was born ready, and I was already on fish and spaghetti. Creep with the culture, rap, I could coach ya, attack like a vulture. See what I told ya, said I'd get ya, rare if it fit ya. The 13 inches, I see the big picture. We own the city, on the phone with Diddy, red bone pretty. When she get aroused like the sucker on, put it in the video. Wanna holler, got to follow, nigga, here we go. Get your ticket. Won't reach out any better, won't visit. To my wardrobe, is it? Listen, make this money, huh? Take this money. Ain't no way you can take this from me. Hey.
Listen, G-Dep would have took us there a little bit faster.
No, he would not.
Listen, internets, welcome back to another episode of the Premium Pete Show with Miss Lissa. Knows Dallas Penn in the fucking building.
Of course.
Wants to call himself a continued guest, you know?
No, we that's too many words.
But listen, Dallas Penn's family, man.
No, because now Dallas Penn is officially our Premium Pete. Like, you would be the other show's host, I would be you, and then you would be the addition.
What the fuck?
I don't even know math no more like that.
All right, cool.
Anyway, internet.
So
listen.
Now you're part of the show is what I'm trying to say.
Okay.
I'm happy to be here, internets.
Listen, DP is back.
I'm really happy to be here. But tonight, I'm happy to be here because the guest mm-hmm. of the Premium Pete Show tonight, internets, Lord Jamar.
Peace.
Peace, God. Listen.
Let's go.
Heard you. That's my new shit. Heard you.
For 5% is straight off the bat.
Yes.
Like, what, just so I remember, it's like, what's today's math? Is that what it is?
Yeah, today's
so can I know?
Wisdom, culture, freedom, all being born in equality.
Heard you.
That sounds good. Sounds good, God. But, yo, listen, one thing I always loved about, and I'm happy that this episode is happening, is because one thing I loved about Lord Jamar, definitely a dude that did multiple things, involved in a great, legendary hip-hop group, Brand Nubian. Mm-hmm. And then when you think about the acting that you did and got involved with, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So, you know, we got a while. And then plus also, Mr. No Filter.
Continued cultural ambassador.
Yes, I like that. Continued cultural ambassador. So you're a CCA.
Let's talk about it.
That's what we're calling. Right off the bat, I want to start off with this.
Wait. Why I got the smush nipple?
Yeah, you can have here.
Lord Jamar got a smush,
right. Smush nipple.
Smush nipple water bottle.
But in levels of green rooms, Lord Jamar.
Yes, sir.
Premium Pete Show would be 10 being best, 1 being lowest.
The green room?
Yeah, just
that we were in just earlier.
Pre-show prep. How do you feel about this spaceship right now that you're flying on? Well,
see, now, if we're going to talk about aesthetics of the room, you know, what? A 4.
Okay.
But the energy and the positivity that goes on within that room and the place that you're able to go to, shit, I'll give you a 9.
Damn, you could get your average up like that? Internet, we could get our average
there's
up.
Different, there's
to
different
9
lanes.
From
there's
4.
Different lanes.
Sir, good to meet you tonight, sir, again. Well, internets, y'all in for a show tonight.
But listen, Dallas, you met Jamar a couple times. Stop smoking that fucking loud, man. You met him a couple times.
Exactly.
So listen, right off the bat, I want to go and talk about what we were talking about before the show started, and that was Lil Yachty. And the reason why I'm bringing that up is because this dude did a Sprite commercial with LeBron James, right?
Right.
So right when I seen that, I was fucking confused. I was like, why the fuck is this dude doing it? But then you brought up a point where it makes you think like, yo, this dude did a Sprite commercial. Like everything.
Well, they point to it as a sign of he must be dope. He must be doing something right. Look, he got a Sprite commercial with LeBron. You see, so for some people in their minds, it validates his talent or lack thereof.
Whose cosign is bigger, LeBron's or Sprite's?
It depends who you're looking at, who you're asking. To the average person in the hood, probably LeBron's directly, But then Sprite is, you know.
Is the one cutting the check.
Right. That's a big look. But, you know, just the fact that LeBron's connected to it. It's like, you know, they know what they're doing. They scientifically putting something together that they think is cool, that the young kids want to buy into.
Formulated.
Absolutely.
Just like they did with those lyrics. With the when they had Drake on the soda can bottle, and they had Rakim, and they had a couple people. But it was like nostalgia. Like, people buy into that shit. Like, oh, shit, Sprite cares about hip-hop. Right?
Hey.
Maybe they do, or maybe they just cut a check.
You know, it could be a little bit of both.
You know, saying that.
Would you take a Sprite check?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because,
Sprite check.
Not to, you know, force the issue, but I can see you would do good works with
right.
that.
Right.
Right.
And it's not like taking, you know, an alcohol check or some shit. Mm-hmm. Although soda's not good for you. Let's, you know.
Okay.
Keep
okay.
it
yeah,
real.
But Sprite helps you, like, you know, if you.
But even an alcohol check, I feel like if good works are done with that.
Yeah. Yeah. That's true. You know what I mean? Absolutely.
You know.
You know, you could use a negative and turn it into a positive. Absolutely.
Right, right, right. And use that as seed money to, you know, to begin good works. I just got to be honest with you. I tell the internets, man, respect the people that, you know, get to the money.
Right.
That create content that allows them to, you know, access that. You know, generate.
But see, here's the thing. The people that are creating the content that's allowing them to access that, a lot of the content is some bullshit.
Right.
See, motherfuckers that got some deep shit, they not offering me no goddamn Sprite contract because I got some real shit to say.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? There's a lot of motherfuckers that, talent-wise, are way more talented, I'd say, than a little Yachty. So why is he there? Because he's popular right now. You know what I mean?
Right.
But,
You ever feel like, you know, I remember.
And his popularity is due to his just mindless bullshit, I'd say.
Yeah, but and the young crowds that are just figuring out who they like and who they don't like. Just,
right, but Lord Jamar says there's also a mathematical formula.
Absolutely.
Which says this specific sound, the way this thing sounds, youthful and dare I say, prepubescent.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, what the fuck did you say?
Prepubescent is what he said.
What is that?
Lord Jamar, this is what we call the Premium Pete Show word of the day.
You said, wait, hold on. How do you, so it's pre?
No, Lord Jamar, I'm sorry.
No instruction?
Hold no.
Pre,
no,
no. Pre-pu-
He has to try. He has to try one time.
But wait, prepubescent? How do you say it? Just
because what happens is he tries
one
time
how it sounds.
And he fucks me up.
No, but I asked you how it sounds.
Prepubescent?
Think about pre-puberty.
Pre-puberty. I mean, yeah. Right? What the fuck, man?
Pre-puberty. Pre-pubescent.
Okay. Yo, so, but anyway. You
say
know
that 10 times fast.
No. But you know what I wanted to say? We had Cool V on there. You know Cool V, mm-hmm. Bismarck, you know,
of
cousin,
course.
Right?
Yes.
So, when he was talking about what he would love to see one day is a tour, you know, a concert with old hip-hop, mm-hmm. young hip-hop, just so the fans could see, like, it's not an old head, and it's not the older heads could see, like, it's not like young cast and really unite people instead of. Now, I know that you have, like, your choice of words against, like, other people. Like, but all the kid needs to do probably with the Yachty is just actually rap. But the point I'm making is, you ever feel like talking to this kid and lending him advice and shit like that just from your
Absolutely.
Experience?
Absolutely. He got up on Ebro and said that he wants to talk to me or some shit mm-hmm. like that. I'd love to talk to the kid. This is not a battle against young and old, like what they're trying to turn it into. This is not some war of the ages. You know what I mean? This is just about the people who come from the foundation of this culture and art form.
Mm-hmm. Hip-hop.
The way they got down, you had to be down by law.
Mm.
Okay? Meaning there are laws and rules to this shit. Now, once you see people just bypassing the law, and they just down, not by law, but they just down, and they're able to fuck with the rules, You know what I mean? We had shit like no biting. And, mm-hmm. You know what I mean? You couldn't even copy somebody's dress style or whatever. Like, mm-hmm. you had to find your own shit. I mean, we had our general shit, of course, Tim's and all that type of shit. But you had to find your own identity as an artist. Like, these days, you got, you know, five motherfuckers that all sound the same and look the same. And, you know what I mean? And is trying intentionally, formulaically, to do the same shit. And this is where problems start to happen. You know what I mean? When, you know, we prided ourselves on writing our lyrics down, you know, at some point, you know, and Hov is kind of responsible for some of this, where they're glorifying, I don't write my shit, you know. Not everybody is as, you know, witty and advanced as a Hov to be able to do that. But he put that out in the air, so now they're feeling like, oh, Hov does it. Like, he don't write his shit. I'm not going to write my shit. Well, your shit sound like you don't write it. You know what I mean? It sound like you didn't think about this shit at all.
Then you get the Migos, who I listen to and I have so much disdain for, but I do be bouncing sometimes. I'd be like, ah. That's like, yo, you sometimes you bounce your head to your
destruction. I can't lie. I don't even be knowing it's the Migos. Like, everybody sounds the same. To me, every time I hear a new Migos song, I'm thinking it's somebody else or whatever. Mm-hmm. And then I found out it's the Migos. And then people say, oh, that's because everybody's biting off the Migos. Mm-hmm. And maybe so. Like, I'm just, you know.
But then you say that maybe the Migos bit off of Das FX. I'm saying you. I'm saying, couldn't people say that? People have said shit like that.
I don't see that.
No?
No, they're not bumpskibbity bumpskitty.
Well, I don't think so. It's a little bit different. But even so, there's a lot of people that you have spoke about that you didn't like. Like a lot of the, you know, young kids doing things that maybe not even is like down by law.
Yeah.
Who are some of the people you do like? Because I feel like people don't ask you that. Like, who are some of the young kids that you do like?
Okay, yeah, let me think about this.
Put the Jeopardy.
I was just thinking that.
But because, nah, I want to make sure, because there's people that, like, I say and then I forget. You know, I don't want to forget these motherfuckers. Definitely somebody like Schoolboy Q.
Mm-hmm.
I like him. I like, I like Kevin Gates.
SP, homeboy.
I like,
Kid Cudi. Don't answer that.
And I don't know enough about him.
Internet, y'all don't get this answer.
You know, I like Kendrick. Mm. I like J. Cole. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, those guys, I like them, but it's not like I'm playing their shit all the time. And they're nasty. Their shit is dope, but it's not. Yeah, I like harder shit. Like, you know what I mean? Mm.
Young M.A.?
Yo, ooh, what's crazy is
they broke though.
Me and my man, Aaron Cooks, that's my artist. See, that's who I listen to, okay. Really. But we were just talking about this earlier, how, like, yeah, we might would rather listen to Young M.A. than, like, a motherfucking, you know, a Yachty or a fucking Uzi Vert or one of these motherfuckers.
Well, at least she's saying something.
Yeah, she could really spit, like, yeah, you know.
She's kind of rhyming.
Yeah, I mean.
She's kind of hard.
She could spit.
Hard rhyming.
I like her shit. It's just, you know, the only thing I don't like is all this promotion of the lesbian shit. I'm not down with that shit. You
Why?
Know what I mean? Why? Because it ain't cool. That's not. That's trying to make the abnormal normal, the unnatural natural. That's something that's.
So you just feel like she shouldn't be promoting or talking about it, or you just feel like she shouldn't be...
She could do whatever she wants to do. I'm telling you what I don't like.
No, I'm asking your opinion on it.
I think there's two kind of lesbians.
I believe we're...
There's white lesbians and black lesbians. And they operate different.
What about the Indian
lesbians? I believe we're living in a society where they're trying to promote homosexuality as a form of birth control. Okay?
Mm.
If two men are together, that don't produce no children. Two women together, that don't produce no children. There, you know, there are other forms of birth control is jail, murder, fucking, you know, separating the men and women, the family structure, period. Mm. You know what I mean? But now promoting all this homosexuality, and they're beating us over the head with it. Like, it's one thing to want to do your thing. See, they don't love homosexuality. Homosexuals. It's just something they're using for their own agenda.
You mean like it's trendy?
Huh?
Like it's trendy? Like,
well, they've made it a trend. It's been created to be a trend.
Lady Gaga said we were born this way.
Bullshit.
I feel like homosexuality has always been what homosexuality is for its whole existence.
Whatever. What is that?
Whatever mathematical fraction. So maybe the fraction is being imbalanced slightly. But homosexuality was always
an imbalance
of the human condition,
of the human mind.
Thank you. Thank you. Everything seems to come out of the mind. Internet.
Like when you think you're other than your own self, something's wrong with you. Mm. If I sat here and told you that I honestly believed I was a dog and wanted to force you to treat me as such, wouldn't you think that's crazy?
Oh, yeah. Wouldn't you think something's wrong with me? I would think you didn't take your medication.
Exactly. So how is me as a man going to sit here and tell you, you know what, I feel like a woman. Treat me as such.
Right.
Because that's how I feel right now. Even though, how do you know how a woman feels? You're not a woman.
Right.
You have a king. You identify with, you know, feminine shit. So what? There's male and female traits in all things. That's the yin and yang in all things. And that doesn't have nothing to do with sexuality and all of that. That's just how the universe is created.
Yeah.
The balance of the universe. But for me to act other than my own self is crazy. But what's even crazier is me forcing you to accept that.
That is
and put it into law.
That, well, hey, man, hold on a second. You said law. Mm-hmm. You didn't say Lord. Mm. Internet's Lord Jamar. Mm.
Peace.
Yo, you know, you know what? Let's take it back. Born in New Rochelle, right?
Mm-hmm. No. I was born in the Bronx.
Okay, born in the Bronx.
Mm-hmm.
Mom and dad.
Raised in New Rochelle. Mm-hmm.
What did mom and dad do?
What'd they do? They just regular working people.
They breathed oxygen.
That's what they did.
They breathed better oxygen than the Bronx. Let's just say no shots, Bronx. I feel you. And I fucks with the Bronx. That's where my folks are.
But
New Rochelle has better air than the Bronx.
I mean, I can imagine that. I can imagine that. It's more
grass,
breathable.
The trees, the mountains. You know, helped Lord Jamar grow, young man. Were you an athlete? Were you an athlete in school?
Mm-hmm.
Basketball? Sure. Football?
Football, baseball.
Sure. Baseball. Mm-hmm. When blacks still played baseball, mm-hmm. well.
Mm-hmm.
You
this
know?
This is when Reggie Jackson and all that type of shit was popping.
Right. So your nose was getting that New Rochelle air. Better than Bronx air.
Well, we was right next to the Bronx.
You was right next, but I'm just saying, if you just county by county, the asthma numbers per capita, less asthma in New Rochelle. That's all I'm saying.
You say capita?
Maybe.
Yes, capita. Okay. When you go over the entire population. Because there's only a small amount of people
we
in New Rochelle.
The same water, you know.
You're getting it before the Bronx.
Orchard Beach and all of that. Yeah, like, you know what I mean?
Pretty much,
same
pretty
shit.
Much. You're right.
Yeah,
you're right.
Long Island Sound.
You're right. I don't know. I feel like when they change the counties, you know, they change things in the infrastructure.
You know? Absolutely. But, you know, I'm just saying, we were in very close proximity to the Bronx.
That's why
New Rochelle benefited, you know, hip-hop-wise, being so close to the Bronx, I feel like. Mm-hmm. You know,
access.
We was up on it very early. You know, Mount Vernon and New Rochelle was up on hip-hop, you know, pretty much right on beat. Whereas, like, if you were further up, let's say, like, White Plains or some shit, you know, I think their start was a little slower. You know what I mean? Yonkers also.
White Plains.
Their Yonkers is
White
right
Plains,
there
it ain't
too.
Your fault. It's your name's fault. Right?
Nah, but White Plains was popping.
Yeah, White Plains was popping.
Mm-hmm.
So, anybody that ever fucks with low or anything fresh knows White Plains gets popping.
White Plains gets popping. But when you were growing up, you said you were born in the Bronx, but then you grew up in New Rochelle.
Mm-hmm.
When did you even get like an inkling that you would want to rap or anything? Or was there something you did before then or that nobody may know?
I mean, you know, when you were a kid, first, you know, everybody thinks, yo, I want to play some sort of sport professionally or whatever, you know what I mean? But then you start to, like, man, a lot of people do this shit all around the country. This shit, you know, am I that good? I don't know. But, I don't know. As soon as I heard hip-hop, I always liked music and shit like that, listening to records and shit like that. But then, I don't know, I was always like a realist with myself. I was like, I can hold a tune, but can I sing like fucking Michael Jackson? Like, no. You know what I mean? So when hip-hop came out, first time I started hearing people rap and shit, I'm like, oh, shit, that's like...
What song was that? Do you remember any song that meant, you know, caught your ear?
Shit, I heard like King Tim the Third. You know what I mean? But then I just had people in the neighborhood, you know, this one kid I remember named Eddie Hull. You know, he was a little older than us, so he went to junior high school. We still in elementary school, but we was about to go to junior high school, you know, within the next year or so.
That and summer.
So he's coming back from junior high school, and he's coming home, and he's saying fucking rhymes and shit like that. And we like, what the fuck is this shit? Like, you know what I mean? Like, shit crazy. And then, yeah, he started playing King Tim the Third, and fucking he's putting us up on, you know, Apache and all this type of shit. You know, they called it bongo rock at the time. And it was just like, yo.
You had to be a part of it.
Yeah, I just... And then now the tapes, bringing tapes through and all of that. And
did you dance at first? Was you trying to be a break dancer?
I did everything that a hip-hop nigga can do.
Dig it.
Graffiti.
Dig it.
Break dance. Popped.
Dig it.
Fucking, but I really started as a DJ, like, you know what I mean?
Really?
Like, yeah.
DJ what?
DJ KD was my name at the time. And you know what KD stands for? Don't laugh too hard. It was Kid Disco.
Oh, I was going to say pardon. So we was going to try to guess it because I was going to say Cool Dust.
No, Kid Disco.
Okay. You wasn't that wild when you was young.
Nah. Kid Disco. Oh, well, I used to smoke dust when I was like, a little.
No, hold on.
Don't a little later on down the line.
Yes. Dust years. We understand that.
Mm-hmm.
We understand
those
that era.
Times.
So Kid Disco.
Yeah, Kid Disco.
Did you get any gigs? Were you
hell
yeah.
Motherfuckers, I was the man in their shell.
Like, really?
Motherfuckers knew me. Hell yeah. And I had my little crew, KD and the Ever-Loving Three. You know what I mean? And you know what I mean? They was my MCs, and they fucking, you know, we was some, like, cool, fly, you know, about getting broads and all that type of shit MCs. Yeah. Like, yeah. You know what I mean? So... You know, we all had waves and fucking, you know.
Spinning.
Mm. And,
no flat tires.
But they was older than me. So it was like, but I looked older. So that was kind of like, we thought that was some sort of like hook. Like, yo, he looks older, but he's really only 15. You know what I mean? Like,
how did even somebody, DJ KD, mm-hmm. And Ever-Loving Three, son? Ever what?
Yep, got it.
How does that even come to forming Brand Nubian? Like, who'd you meet first? Like, did you meet, like, Sadat? So how did you even meet Pooba?
Oh, well, how I met Pooba, by this time, you know, there ain't no more KD and Ever-Loving Three, but I'm still a DJ. Oh, matter of fact, the first time I met Pooba, since everybody knew I was a DJ, he called me out of the blue to borrow a turntable because one of his turntables conked out or some shit. And
not even the DJ, though, just to borrow the turntable.
Right.
So to bring the turntable.
Or to come pick it up.
He would come pick it up.
Like somebody, you know, he had an emergency. Now, mm-hmm. Keep in mind, Pooba is famous in New Rochelle at this time.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You know what I mean? Okay. So...
You getting called up.
I'm getting calls from, you know, I've walked in people's cribs and they got flyers with Pooba taped to their wall and this type. This before he even made a record. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
so you're getting called up to the majors, kind of.
Yeah, I'm getting a call from, like, the big guy in their shell. So it's like, I don't know, whatever the fuck. You want my turntable? Here. You know what I mean? Whatever. So I let him use the turntable. Boom. That's how we first met. Yes, I got my turntable back, but nobody housing my shit. Matter of fact, I used to house a lot of people's shit. I had to cobble together equipment at first. So I'm like, yo, let me hold your shit, man. Like, you know, I'm really better than you. So mm-hmm. I need the shit. Like, you know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. get a turntable from this dude, one from this dude. I got the mixer. Bang. The shit's at my crib now.
Next thing you know, you got a whole system. Here.
But I had the crib where I could hang out. You know, people could hang out at my crib. A lot of people, you know, their parents was real, you know, on some bullshit. Fortunately, mine was cool. So anyway.
So Pooba called you, borrowed equipment.
Yeah, he borrowed equipment. Relationship. Well, yeah, just as far somewhat, as he knows. I know who he is. Yeah. He knows who I am, blah, 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 blah. So now, you know, I'm on my own. You know, I'm DJing, but I'm now also MCing and shit. I'm running up on ciphers. I'm running up in the park, wherever. Wherever I see a mic, if niggas got turntables and niggas is rhyming, I'm trying to run up and say my shit. You know what I mean? So one day, there's a block party, Lincoln Park. We niggas is out there rhyming. It's my turn to rhyme. Right on cue, Poobah walks in with his cousin, Doctor Who. Mm-hmm. You know, now they're the master of ceremonies at this time, you know what I mean? And they're about to come out. They already got a record, but it's a record called Crime that probably a lot of y'all never heard of before.
That's not the one that goes diggum.
Nah.
Okay. That's Masters of Ceremony.
That's about to come out at this time. That's not out yet.
That's just being performed live, like.
Not yet. You know what I mean? When I'm mating him, not yet. Mm. So they got a record. So that was big. Niggas from New Rochelle got a record. Bang. So now I'm rhyming and shit. I see him walking the park. And I see him pointing at me like, yo, that's that kid I was telling you about. Da 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 da. And whatever. I got off the mic. He ran up on me. Yo, I want to work with you. Blah, 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 blah. All right, let's do it. You know what I mean? And then we started. You know, but that was like trying to do some solo shit for me or whatever, you know. Mm-hmm. Then time passed. He told me, yo, I met this other kid, man. Yo, this dude is nice. Like, and I was like, who? And he was like, Derek X. And I was like, yo, he is nice. Because I had met X one time in a cypher. Mm-hmm. And he was one of the only kids around my age that I thought was nice. Mm-hmm. And so I was like, yeah, that kid is nice. You should work with him.
Tell me how cyphers work. I mean, were there known, like for graffiti writers, there were like benches. There were spots where people would convene. Mm-hmm. Were there specific corners for ciphers? I imagine maybe Fordham Road had one. 125th Street had one.
Nah, that's something that would just pop up. That's a spontaneous thing, like a pop-up shop. Mm. You know what I mean? You don't know where a cipher's going to pop up at. Mm. You know what I mean? But first of all, a real cipher comes from the 5% nation of being in a cipher and building on the day's math and all that and, you know, on the lessons and shit. That's where the term cipher even comes from. Mm. Then it got transformed because a lot of MCs, you know, were in the 5% nation. The term of standing in a circle and saying rhymes became a rhyme cipher. Mm-hmm. And then they just took the word rhyme off, and now they're just calling that a cipher. But really, a real cipher, you know, you're showing and proving that you know your lessons and all that type of shit. That's what a real cipher is. So that's the ciphers we really used to have first. But, you know, rhyme ciphers were going on simultaneously.
Do you ever think, where does that language transmission come from? Prior to being 5%, it wasn't always 5%. Is this some particular African custom to take language, to recreate it, to reinvent it?
Well, the African, we invented language. Our language is the foundation of all languages. So that's what we do. We can take any kind of language and there's thousands of languages just on the continent of Africa alone. sometimes hundreds, thousands just within one country.
That's the truth.
That just shows our ability to take language and flip it and balance it in infinite ways, depending on our circumstance, you know, whether it's geographically, politically, spiritually, economically.
Damn. I'm glad these microphones have on stands, because these shits would be falling. Boom.
Hey, boom. Jules dropping. But listen, so boom. So he tells you about Sadat, and where did that even progress into, where you met up or even like anything to start? Just for people who know a Brand Nubian, knowing that backstory of like.
Right. Well, we're going to the studio at his manager's crib, you know what I mean? Trying to get work done. And that was like a hurdle because, you know, that motherfucker wasn't really serious or whatever. He was fucking with coke and shit at the time, you know. But it's the 80s, you know. So anyway, time goes on. His group, Master Ceremonies, breaks up after, you know, they had a couple hits, Cracked Out, Sexy. Mm-hmm. And then an album that I guess didn't do as well as people thought it should have. So they broke up. In my mind, I always believed I should have been in Master Ceremonies. Mm-hmm. Anyway, so, you know, I remember, you know, me in the mall and Poobah kind of seemed like, you know, unsure about what direction he wanted to take or whatever, da 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 da. And I
was, personally, you talk about?
You know, I guess artistically or whatever the case may be as an artist, you mm-hmm. know what I mean?
Y'all was at the mall?
Yeah, we were walking through the Nourishel Mall.
Nourishel Mall. Did he get this epiphany after stopping by and getting an Orange Julius?
I don't even know what the fucking Orange Julius is.
What the fuck is an Orange Julius?
And, that's some old mall head shit.
I don't know what you're talking about.
That's the original fake smoothie.
Yo, a side note, before we get back to the former diabetes. Brand Nubian. Hilfiger and how much Pooba fucked with Hilfiger. They say Tommy reached out to him and definitely was sending him boxes and shit like that, you know? Do you know, like, how, like, did Tommy even care that he was rocking it? Because he...
Why would you care about what Tommy felt? Did Tommy send you boxes?
No.
So Pooba didn't get you to get boxes?
Who cares? Pooba's not sitting here. We're sitting here with Lord Jamar.
No.
I want to know at that time. Why are we asking him what Pooba's business was?
I don't... You know what I mean? I don't fully.
Did Hilfiger send you a box?
No, he ain't send me.
Okay, so then the chances that they sent Derek Sadat X a box is also likely. Right, all right.
Okay, let's get back to Brand Nubian. So you're walking through the mall.
Walking through the mall. I'm like, man, you know it'd be dope, man, if fucking me, you, and that kid X fucking come together and make a group. And he's. Word. Yeah, that sounds like some shit right there. And then it was just like.
And then who came up with a name?
Oh, we didn't have no name. We were shopping without a name.
Really?
We were shopping with no music.
Okay.
Y'all
wasn't calling yourselves the Marvelous Three, though. Y'all had moved on from that, right?
Nah, we wasn't calling ourselves nothing at
How
that
did
time.
The name Brand Nubian come up?
It just, Poobah. Had connections, you know, from the Sexy and all of that. So that was good. So we were able to take meetings on Poobah strength without any music.
Right.
So
you would just do like in studio performances or something, like give them a feel of what you.
No.
You just,
We just go down there and pretty much be like, yeah, well, we looking for a record deal. You know what I mean?
Hey, I want no records yet.
Could you do that then? Could you really not have any music?
Anything? I don't Pooba's, know. We were young. And we were following his lead.
Okay,
at that
so Pooba's swag was so. I mean, Pooba was nice. Certainly,
listen, these motherfuckers was loving him.
Yeah,
you know
Masters
what I mean?
Of Ceremony was
so
dope.
So we was walking in a couple dope of doors. Jam. We walked in a couple of doors.
Yeah,
and then so we walks up into Tommy Boy, which was popping at the time. Mm-hmm. De La Soul, all that type of shit, and fucking Dante Ross was there.
Mm-hmm. Shout out to Dante Ross.
Yeah.
Shout out to Dante Ross. So, you know, he's like, yo, Poobah, you know, whatever you do, like, I love your shit. Like, I want to fuck with you, you know? Then he's like,
yo, that's how Dante Ross sounds.
He's like, your boys, you know, you know, I'm sure they're dope, but, you know, I'm going to need to hear something, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So he's like, yo, you know, make me a demo or some shit and, you know, come back so I could play it, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. All right, cool. So, you know, at that time, we ain't had studio money and all that type of shit. So, you know, Pooh Bah's cool with Jazzy J from Zulu Nation. Shout out Jazzy J. He had a studio up in Allerton Avenue, Strong City Studios. So we go up there. We used to be chilling up there anyway. So now we up there, like, trying to get spared studio time, like, sitting through other people's sessions and waiting till the end of the night. And then, like, if Jay feels like he's not too tired, maybe, you know, he'll let us fucking sample some shit or whatever the case may be. You know what I mean? Uh-huh. And then record and all of this. So long story short, it took us about 2 weeks to put together one song.
Mm. What song was
it? You know
what
I mean? It's called I Ain't Going Out Like That. Mm. It's on the internet somewhere.
Internets.
I think. But we didn't put it out at the time. So we recorded that shit. Shit was hot. We played it for Dante. He's like, yo, this is crazy. He was like, yo, I just got a job at fucking Elektra. You know, I want to bring y'all over there. Like, y'all could be the first people I sign over there. Like, fuck this Tommy Boy shit, you know? Like, that's a bigger label and all that type of shit, you know? So we was like, fuck it. He was like, oh, but, you know, now all y'all got to do, so what's y'all's name? Like, you know? And he was like, oh, we ain't got a name. He was like, all right, well, y'all going to have to come up with a name. And he was like, all right, we'll be back. You know what I mean? We went back up to Jazzy J's, and we had, like, a name session.
Oh.
You know what I mean? Like,
so what names did not make it?
See, we've heard this before. Okay, so I've said this in the other interviews.
I apologize. So, yeah. I apologize.
No, that's they were Stewie, some stupid shit. Like, one of the names.
The Three Rascals.
No. We knew that, like, at some point, we knew that the word Nubian, we wanted that incorporated in some way. You know what I mean? But I remember a dumb one that was out there was, like, Nubian Force. Like, and I remember I didn't like the Force part.
Okay,
Nubian Force.
What was your favorite comic book of all time?
I'm not a comic book head. Oh, you know what I mean? But I used to fuck with comic books, but
what comic book did you fuck with?
I don't know. Batman and Superman,
that's all?
Shit like that.
Batman is Batman's mm-hmm. one of the best. Batman and Spider-Man, one
Aquaman,
of the best.
Aquaman, all of that.
Aquaman's
Spider-Man.
Fucked up. Aquaman's fucked up. Aquaman is fucked up. His hair's blonde.
Type,
you
all
know
those,
you can't
all
be
those
Aquaman.
Type of shits that came on.
Batman or Spider-Man, you could be. Spider-Man, you could be because you never
Spider-Man
seen Spider-Man.
Yes, I did fuck with Spider-Man.
You never seen
him.
You
making me remember some shit that I.
No, I'm just trying to figure out where, like, you know, what gave y'all. I mean, the name Brand Nubian. I really hope that y'all have that patented, copywritten, something, because the Nubian brand is everlasting.
Mm.
Yeah, that was, you know.
And who knew that branding? Y'all was ahead of the letting us know branding was going to be so important.
Yeah. Your brand was Nubian.
Right.
Yeah.
And that's what we said, kind of. Brand, and it sounded like Brand New, Brand Nubian. And I was. And then
went back
that
to
went on, and no, we took a vote that night. And
just
then
a bunch of black people.
We voted Brand
language.
Nubian won over mm-hmm. whatever the other names was.
What was the other name?
That's what I'm saying. Nubian Force is the only one I remember. I don't remember no other shit, but there were some other ones, too. That
they had
know,
some crazy, like, mystery crew.
So moving with... And forming Brand Nubian.
Now Rue Mob maybe might have been one.
Rue Mob? Mm-hmm.
Now Rue
Mob. Now Rue Mob.
Okay. Mm-hmm. That might have been
okay,
one.
Okay, now there it goes.
Yeah.
But even with forming Brand Nubian and getting signed to Elektra, you mm-hmm. know, with Dante Ross, how did you even know, like, you know, you started DJing, how did you even know what to get, like, as far as, like, publishing or money-wise, like, like, how did you know what I mean?
We don't know that.
No, I'm saying, how did you even, like, you know, maneuver through all that shit?
Like anybody else, ignorant maneuvers through it the best way you
was
can.
That a bad deal, the first deal?
Of course.
Yeah.
Of course. We had our first lawyer was like, some shiesty motherfucker named Larry Leiter and shit. He's probably dead now.
Did he wear cheap suits?
Absolutely.
You don't never trust a lawyer with
cheap suits. Larry Leiter. And he's probably dead because he was old as fuck back then.
Fuck him.
So, yeah.
Larry, if you're not
but he was so stupid, like, that, like, when we got a real lawyer, they was like, oh, this motherfucker's trying to, rob y'all. But it was like.
Even Pooba had the experience of these meetings, of these.
Listen, that doesn't make you.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Like,
they send another thing at you. They send another curveball at you.
It's like Pooba probably had a bad deal at Strong City. Mm-hmm. Then the next deal looks better than the Strong City deal. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
But not that that's all that great either.
Right. Like, and this group now has more people than the one he had before. So the deal should look better because there's more people. But I don't know. I don't even want to talk about money.
Hey, listen. What money?
Lord Jamar, what does money mean in 2017? No, that's a silly question. What do politics and society and culture mean in 2017? What does culture mean?
Again, it's all who you're talking to, who you're asking. Like, there's different cultures for different people. You know what I mean? Like, I keep telling these motherfuckers, like, there's a black world and there's a white world. Okay? Whether you want to accept it or not. In the mainstream white world, David Bowie is the shit. In the mainstream black world, people don't give a fuck about David Bowie.
Nah, he's cool.
He's cool, but he's not to the level of that Prince. The mainstream white people praise David Bowie.
Of course. Yes, we understand that. But we also understand that he is not as ill as Prince.
Exactly. He's not.
But also,
so when they try to be like, yo, Prince and Dave Bowie and George Michael, I'll be like, hold the fuck on.
So the reason I'm bringing this up is because it's showing you there's different cultures. And like, certain shit is important depending on what culture you're talking about. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Dig it.
The Beatles don't mean shit to me. Compared to the Jackson 5 or the Temptations.
I'm here, don't worry.
Yeah. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
But to white people, to mainstream white people,
Right.
The Beatles are but then there's always the exception to the rule, you know?
Like Steely Dan. They white.
You following Steely Oates. Dan?
Hall & Oates. Or your boy.
I don't know about nobody else.
Okay. Forget. What's that nigga?
Michael McDonald.
Yeah, Michael McDonald. You see what I'm saying? Like.
Yo, that dude had gray hair forever.
And had the coolest motherfucking voice.
Yeah. Hold on a second.
As a motherfucker.
He did a song with Patti LaBelle.
Oh, that was amazing.
Elton John?
Elton John wasn't shit.
Right.
No. Elton John. I like
Elton John. Ain't shit is what I'm saying.
He had a song. Hold on. He had a song that I dedicated to my father.
Okay.
Well, me and him were going through some very hard times. It's called Father and Son.
Okay.
And if anybody ever listens to that shit, yo, real talk, man. Me and my pops had a moment for years we didn't get along.
Okay. When I see now play that next to Luther Vandross' Dance
course,
with My Father.
Hold on a second. Pete.
Murdered!
Pete will post these Instagram pictures with his family. And I look at Pete, and sweet Pete's little face, looks like they put lipstick on him.
He got them fat lips, too. He got the coolies.
Like, yo, was your family?
He got Jay-Z lips.
Okay, they didn't put lipstick on. Did they gloss your lips?
No. I was telling him. Back in the day, like, my lips were red, real red.
And they was plump.
Like, real talk. Like, I don't know why it was red, man. Like, real red.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
No, but honestly, you know what? Not going away from what the hell we're talking about. But one thing I always tell Dallas that I love is that I always see all these throwback pictures of Dallas. And I look at them, I'm like, damn, who the fuck was, how did he get to take all these pictures when he's young? Because I was moving around a knucklehead since I didn't think of always taking pictures. You know, I could have shown right now, you know, I could show people back in the day the kicks, the fit, you know, all that shit is classic. You know what I mean?
Word. Because Dallas was definitely a high yellow joint. I was looking at Thurston Howell's book and page 143, Dallas Penn.
Hold on a second. You got a copy of Thurston Howell's book?
Yeah. You don't?
No.
Well. Anyway, the point
I got a copy. The point with the low on.
No doubt.
Now he let us borrow it. Low doubt. He let us borrow it.
But
it's on loan.
The point I'm making too is that we today take more pictures than we ever did.
Because we have it on our phone.
Yeah, because everybody got a fucking
picture. But most definitely. But what I'm saying, that's a good thing, because when you look back, sometimes memories, you get a lot of memories through those pictures. You know what I mean?
Sometimes you get a lot of years through them pictures too, and the feds is watching. They be like, ha-cha-cha, go in the comment section, go over here, look at that tag, look over there, lockdown. Done.
Not to sound all crazy, but hold on for a second. They put out, I don't know whether it's fake news or not, but the Echo device, they made somebody's Echo device get researched. Because he killed somebody or some shit. And the Echo device is some phone integrated house assistant that you talk to and records you, and it kind of just studies you, you know.
Niggas is using Siri voice? Like, I know what you did last summer.
God bless, man. God bless. But anyway.
Siri gonna call you up.
Anyway, where the fuck were we before we went off on pitches?
Man, just.
Somebody remind me, because flying
through the universe.
Oh, yeah,
this crew is weeded out.
Culture.
Okay, politics. Yes. Your accent. Who you accent?
Don't sound so enthusiastic.
But you know what?
Just kidding. Just getting back to it.
That was a retarded question. But two, bro. You know why? I really pull myself back down to politics. And how do young black people? I go to black people first, because there's white people, black people. And non-white people.
What's a non-white people?
Non-white person is someone not black.
Chinese, Indian,
I thought it was
but not
the other
white.
Way around. No,
Russian.
I thought there was black people and white people. And if you're not black, you white, like Spanish white.
No, you're still non-white.
White.
Well, you think an Asian can
ain't no non-white.
White?
It's either you the front of the bus or the back.
What do black people need to continue through 4 years, through 8 years of
grabbing by the pussy?
You just gave him 8 years?
I'm just saying. What do... If people should make an 8-year plan, maybe they should make a 10-year plan.
Because why? He going to add stuff? It's like a Second Avenue train station. Shit that's not supposed to happen just going to happen. He going to add years. F-Train going to Queens now. Like, okay. 8, 10 years.
I mean, black people are going to be doing what we've been doing. You know what I mean? It just depends on... What is he going to do? You know what I mean? What is... Nobody knows what these next, at least 4 years, are going to look like. That's what's so crazy. Like, there's no thermometer, necessarily. You never had such a obviously volatile person, you know, in the White House like that. At least not in a long time that I could remember.
Mm-hmm. Bush?
Not Bush.
I don't think Bush was volatile.
Bush was just stupid.
Yeah.
He was a little stupid,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, he was volatile, but he was just stupid. Now, I think this guy's smarter than Bush.
Mm-hmm. But I don't know.
But he's more motivated by his ego. Mm-hmm. And that's what's very dangerous. Yeah. Like, he's on some real lower self shit, and he don't let shit go, and that could be dangerous.
Yeah. Well, even more than dangerous, just amazingly scary to live in this world that someone who is our president is emotional and will tell you over Twitter.
Right.
Will tell you that, you know, like, I don't like the way someone did this, you know.
And will just make up shit.
Yeah.
Well, like, they showed... Obviously, the crowds wasn't as big as Obama's shit.
Yeah.
And he's presenting now something called alternative facts. Mm. Like, what the fuck is that?
He got other angles?
Alternative facts are just lies.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's all it is.
He now, filters. Y'all ain't use this picture.
Now his ego, he's mad that Hillary supposedly beat him in the popular vote.
Yes, yes. Yeah.
So he's claiming that there were over 3.5 million illegal votes on behalf of Hillary. Yet he's delivering no proof of that. And everybody's saying that's bullshit. Like, that would be the biggest voting scandal in history.
Yeah, right. but numbers-wise, it's still kind of a threshold where you'd be like, man, get the fuck out of here. What is 3.5 million people to the population, the overall population of America? 1%? What's 3.5 million
still, in a voting? He still didn't win. You see, in an egotistical person's mind, mm-hmm. you want to win at everything. And mm-hmm. you're going to figure out, if I didn't win, well, it must have been because da-da-da-da-da. Okay. But I'm Donald Trump. I know I'm more popular than her. So what the fuck? There must have been voter fraud.
Right.
You know what I mean?
There was definitely voter fraud. He's mad because he only had 1 million illegal votes. Where Hillary actually had a total of 6 million illegal votes. Mm. That's why he's mad. He didn't have enough illegal votes.
I don't know if there's illegal votes or not.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, this motherfucker is motivated by ego, and that's, you know, which a lot of people are, but his shit is just really blatant. Like, he's just on some real base level shit.
You never know what's illegal, man. I mean, listen, the Russians could get insurance for you for like 5 years straight in the computer, you know, mm-hmm. for $500.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you never know what's illegal.
Yeah.
I mean, people could just do anything these days. Back in the day, I remember people were getting GEDs. What score you want?
Hmm.
You know, $150. Okay. Mm. I'll take the highest score. It's in the system? Yes. No, but most definitely. So
you got a 1200 on your GED?
I don't remember, man. Whatever it was. I told him, give me the system. I just want to make sure it's in the system. You'd be surprised, man. Be surprised. But you know what? You know what? Let's go to a break, and then we'll come back. I want to go over some of the acting, just some other stuff. We talk about a little bit more Brand Nubian, Lord Jamar.
Yes, yes.
Anyway, internets, don't go nowhere. You listen to the Premium Pete Show, Missless and Nose, Dallas Penn in the building, Lord Jamar. Be right back. Cheer.
Yeah, you already know. Low Life's in the building. Polo Weekend, Thurston Howell III. This is the Premium Pete Show right now. With Miss Lissa Knows, she thinks she knows, but I'm telling otherwise right now. My boy Dallas Penn in the building was good.
Ow.
Internet, and we're back.
Yo, crazy internet, did we just put y'all to sleep almost?
I don't know. That first half, I felt like I didn't have enough
Do
energy.
Do not so. Fall asleep.
No, no.
All
no.
right?
Nah, they just got to smoke while they listen so they feel like they with y'all in the groove.
Or get that blueberry Red Bull. Listen, get a glass, plastic or glass of ice. And pour that blueberry.
Let him get a glass. Let him get a mug. Let him get something, you know, porcelain.
That blueberry Red Bull.
Yeah.
Listen.
Do it classy for the Super Bowl.
We spoke about.
Don't throw your cup at the TV, though.
Don't do that. Well, listen. We spoke about Brand Nubian. We spoke about, like, you know, how it formed and the names and stuff. One thing I like is how you were able to diversify yourself. Being on Oz. You know, Supreme right. Allah.
We just going to skip every Brand Nubian.
No, we're going to go over Brand Nubian. We'll go back. Okay, listen, okay. This is organized chaos. So we'll go back to a couple of things from Brand Nubian. But I want to know, how the hell did you get into acting? Like, how did you even score Supreme Allah on the Oz?
Word.
Well, basically, that one I feel is just, it's just the power of the mind.
Mm-hmm.
When you just decide some shit. You know, and your mind is strong.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, you can make things happen. You know, and
you Professor X that shit.
Basically, like, I always felt like acting was some shit I could do. You know? Then there was a period where, like, a lot of rappers was getting in movies and shit like mm-hmm. that and doing horrible jobs. And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, I could do way better than this shit. Like, how the fuck... Why am I get belly? Up in there?
How this nigga getting belly?
So, I'm not no belly. I don't like belly,
you
but
I'm
you know what I'm saying.
I wanted to see
Yeah, I'm not gonna get all into that, but anyway. So I'm thinking, how you get into it? Maybe people just approach you with some shit. I didn't even know how you get into it. I was just thinking, you know, well, yeah, this I'm do this rap shit. Somebody's gonna approach me about this shit sooner or later. You know what I mean? Later comes, nobody ever approached me. Shit. So I'm like, what the fuck? So finally, when I say it out loud, that's part of it too, you see. You take what's... Well, see, thoughts are like in a different dimension almost. Mm-hmm. You got to bring them from that dimension into this dimension, okay? And how you do that is to, like, you can write some shit down or you can speak it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So when I said out loud, you know what? I want to do some acting shit, you know? And then I hit up my manager at the time, Jeff Dixon and shit. I'm like, yo, y'all want to do some acting shit, man? Like, I see all these rapping. Yo, get me in a fucking movie or some shit. Like, you know, get me an audition or some shit. Like, you know what I mean? So, you know, he's probably thinking, where the fuck's this coming from? So, anyway, I don't know. Shortly after I said that, he's like, all right, they're having a premiere for a new show on HBO and shit. You know what I mean? I got y'all tickets to go there or whatever. You know what I mean? I'm like, fuck it.
Go there just to network, hang out?
Yeah, I guess Okay. Basically to network. You know what I mean? So we go. The show turns out to be The Sopranos.
Oh,
really?
You know, yeah. And just mad people from HBO was there. So a lot of people from Oz was there.
Did you go up to David Chase and say, listen, motherfucker?
I didn't even know who the fuck David Chase was. You know what I mean? I just knew the motherfuckers from Oz and shit like
that. What about Paulie Walnuts? You didn't go up to Paulie Walnuts?
They weren't famous at this time.
Okay.
This was the premiere of the shit.
But was his hair on the gray and shit on
the
side?
Yes, yes, yes.
Slick the fuck up?
Yeah,
Okay, no problem.
Great guy. Met him later.
Okay.
Anyway. So we start meeting all these people from fucking Oz and shit. And they're like, oh, shit, Brand Nubian. You know what I mean? Like, yo. Matter of fact, Michael Rappaport was there that day. This motherfucker. And I think that was the first time we met him. And he comes up and just starts spitting a verse from, like, an obscure Brand Nubian song. Like, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I was like, yo, that's fucking it. And he said the whole fucking verse.
He did the verse from your demo.
Not that obscure.
Okay.
But anyway, so we go to the after party. We hanging out with dude. We smoking weed and motherfucking in some restaurant and all that type of shit. And I ended up getting cool that night with my man Dean Winters, the one that played O'Reilly and shit. Mm-hmm. Long story short, you know, a couple years could have gone by, I don't know, a year or two or whatever, but you know, we would just go to parties sometimes. That he'd invite us to certain shit here and there. He invited us to the set one time, blah 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 blah. You know, we talk on the phone here and there, you know. And matter of fact, I don't know if it was years, actually. It might have been a year. Anyway, he hits me up one day and he's like, yo, would you ever want to be on the show? I was like, hell yeah. You know what I mean?
Was the show? The show was already airing at this time.
Yeah, it's
season two or something.
Yeah, when I got in, it was like season four.
Yeah. It's already floating on.
Yeah, it's like, see, yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
It's going into season four, I guess. Mm. It's about to be season four, and then he's like, "All right, I'm gonna get back to you." He hits me like a week later. He's like, "Yo, Tom Fontana, want to meet with you?" Da 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 da. Now that's the creator of Oz. You know, I go in there. And I don't know what homeboy said to him, but Tom Fontana's talking to me like I'm already down. Like, he ain't even, you know, heard me read nothing. Mm-hmm. I didn't audition nothing. Like,
yeah,
he's just kind of interviewing me as far as, like, what could your character be?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And he's asking me all this other shit. You know, what would I be willing to do and not do? You know what I mean? Because they'd be doing some funny shit on there.
You weren't trying to add a BC like type nothing. Shit, right?
Yeah, he knew I wasn't down with that. Like,
now, there's not for you, because I know you stand stronger to what you believe in.
Mm-hmm.
But some people, you know, listen, if you throw a couple extra million or a couple hundred thousand, they do, you know, they do whatever the fuck.
See, that you going to somebody's wild. Somebody might not even have to give them no money at all.
This is the definition of selling out, though.
Somebody might not even take no money at all. What about them? You didn't include them. The people that do it for free.
Mm.
Yeah, well, they still they're doing it for the what they think is the exposure or whatever the case may be.
The culture.
It's still selling out even if you don't get money for it.
Damn. Even if you ain't get paid for it, you sold out. Damn.
Depending on the circumstances.
All right, well, then get your money.
Yeah, so long story short, I gave him the, you know, he never heard of the 5% Nation and all of that, so I gave him that, you know, came up with the name. And
Supreme Allah.
Mm-hmm. Fucking put me in there.
How long were you on there for?
Like 12 episodes.
Okay. That's dope. Yeah. Then they killed you off?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Money was good, too?
Yeah, it was nice.
Nice. Now, what network was that?
HBO.
HBO, shit, you're right. And then even, were you saying don't what? You want me to go into his pockets?
No, you. I feel you're about to hand Lord Jamar a fucking
W-9. No, always, no. The reason why I asked for it is because you especially spoke on it, about exposure. Sometimes people take, you know, a little bit of money just for the opportunity. And being that was the first time, you know.
Right. Oh, yeah. Well, I wasn't getting, like, you know.
Yeah.
Like, I was the star money. Like, yeah. I was getting what a regular motherfucker would get, I guess, you know, who was at the level of what I was doing. Like, I wasn't getting no extra, like I was an extra type of shit. It was good.
It was
like,
good money. Great.
Now that, was there a check for dying, though? Like you know, boom, like the funeral cost?
Supreme Allah. May he rest in peace.
No.
You know, Dallas even asked you off air, we were talking about craft services.
Right.
How was Oz Craft Services?
You know, that depends if you were SAG or non-SAG.
Ooh. Mm-hmm. Wow, really?
And so that's really on all sets, I guess. You know what I mean? But yeah.
And SAG, for the people who don't know, is not Sagittarius. It's
The Screen Actors Guild.
That would be the SAG.
Well, it depends.
If you're in the Screen Actors Guild, then you can go, you know,
eat better?
And go to lunch. You know what I mean? Like, and have the craft services where they got, you know, little sandwiches and cakes and donuts,
what is
and
cutting
candies and bags of chips and all of that. Whereas on the, if you're not in SAG, you know, for those extras that was getting like $75 a day or some shit, you know.
Peanut butter and jelly
It'd just
sandwich?
Be like a box of donuts.
Yeah, oh, wow. Just a
like
bowl
a couple
of
box of donuts on the, apples, on a, and like a coffee, thermos, and that's it. Like,
well, I'll tell
you what I mean.
I learned a trick in prison. The regular food was garbage, and so I just told them I was kosher. You know, and the kosher meal is missing that Skittles and that bitch. You understand? Yeah, they don't fucking play around. Rabbi will come out, fucking turn the
but
plate upside down.
You had the complexion. To flourish.
I had the nose of you know, to pass as a horror.
Wait, Skittles though. You know? Skittles aren't kosher.
No, but they had candy, they had cereal, they had better meals. I don't remember exactly what some of them were.
I was gonna say Skittles. We didn't eat Skittles as the gods because that had swine in it.
That had pork
really?
In it. Right? Yeah. Everything has pork in it.
Fuck.
Yeah. So I know you didn't have Skittles in there.
Yeah. Plus Skittles just taste the rainbow. I don't see the gods putting the rainbow in their mouth.
Well, first of all, let me just say, as far as the rainbow, like, they trying to hijack that imagery, like, with all this gay shit. Like, that's just the colors of the chakras. Mm-hmm. That's the colors of your fucking, you know.
That's Roy G. Biv.
Of the prism of light. Like, you know what I mean? Like, and they're trying to, like, hijack that shit so you don't want to fuck with that whenever you see some rainbow shit. But
the
rainbow is with inside you. And it ain't nothing gay about the rainbow.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
No pause needed for that.
Throughout your, you know, years of living, you have anybody in your family who ever turned or admitted that they were gay?
They're probably scared.
Nah.
Don't do it around Jamar. Don't do it around
Jamar. I got one gay friend.
Nah, first of all, hold up. Like, what the fuck's that even mean? Don't do it around you.
No,
I'm going to wild out on you or something. That's not what it's about.
No, I don't mean that. Meaning that they probably want to just, you know, how people don't want to come out of the closet, so to speak.
Listen, I had a female cousin that was, you know, supposedly gay or whatever.
Okay,
but again, she went through a trauma too, though. Okay. You see what I'm saying? Which a lot of them go through, that people don't want to talk about that part of. You know what I mean? but because she wasn't always gay, you know, went through a trauma, and then now you're gay all of a sudden. You know what I mean? Like, come on, like, let's talk about it.
Yo, what are the permutations that you can go from, starting from, say, being a woman? Okay, you could go gay.
I don't even know what permutations, what the fuck are you talking about? Is that okay, your hair?
Okay, that'll be another Premium Pete Show word of the day. You could go gay, or you could go Chaz Bono, go man.
You could change into Jewish.
All right, that's right. You could go kosher.
Okay. You know, what might want to be left-handed, be right-handed.
But think about that, internet. That's the question for y'all to answer. I'm still high over here.
Yo, okay, so moving on with doing Oz, right? How did even, you know, and I love this. I love that you were a part of this. But how the fuck did you even get to Sopranos? I mean, obviously you're an HBO family, friends with different people.
Honestly, people say that a lot. Like, I just did The Night Of, too. That was some HBO shit. But I don't think it's really like that. Like...
No?
It just happened to be, they happen to be on HBO. I don't think it's, because they don't all have the same, like, casting directors and shit like that. Like, it's not necessarily a lot of intertwining like that. You see what I'm saying?
And these things aren't funded beforehand by HBO. They're just produced.
Right.
And then HBO goes and buys them.
Okay. So now... Oz, that was the first thing I got. Now, that one, I didn't have to audition all of that. Everything else, I had to fucking audition for.
Even Sopranos.
Absolutely. How'd that go down? Got a call for, Sopranos, you know what I mean? Audition, because I got a manager for acting. So, got a call, Sopranos, went down there, did my thing, you know what I mean?
What were they, what was the that we're trying to have you act for or read? What they wanted you is what you got?
I think what I read for is not what I ended up getting. What I ended up getting was better than what I originally went there for, I think. Yeah, me and Tretch were in the scene together. I think Mums was in it too, from Oz. Anyway, but I did a lot of stuff between that. You know what I mean? I've been on Third Watch. I've been Law and Order.
Which one? Because there's so many.
I've been on SVU twice, and I've been on the regular one with Jerry Orbach and your brother Jesse Martin.
You enjoy acting better than the rap, you know, like being in acting, being in rap, or same shit?
Yeah, I just like creative shit. You know what I mean? I like working with a team and shit, so...
Was it difficult selling yourself as an actor because you had worked before and you had long hair? Did you find like that was a transformation that you had to sell people on?
Well, I think that the timing of me cutting my hair was helpful as far as, I guess, getting up. Other roles and shit. Like, I ended up getting roles with my dreads.
Right.
You know, even after Oz and all of that. But, you know, that does kind of limit you. But that's not why I cut my hair. You see what I'm saying? Like,
what was the reason?
You know, I had proved my point. I had them for 12 years. You know, the time that I grew dreads, a lot of people wasn't doing it.
Sure.
And, you know, it represented more of a, you know, black rebellion type of thing, you know. Now, you know, everybody and their mama got dreads, and it's a whole nother...
I've seen a Chinese dude the other day with
mentality.
Dreads.
Mentality.
Isn't it now that, like, they passed a law where employers can say that locks are inappropriate or out of dress code? Something like that?
I think that was back in the day they were saying
no,
that.
No, they just they probably said something
in South
new.
Carolina, North Carolina, some... One of the Carolinas probably has something like that.
Yeah.
The one that has the Confederate flag still flying.
Listen, what I want to know is how was it working with Tony Soprano or James Gandolfini, so to speak?
It was great. Because not only James Gandolfini was in the scene, but also an actor by the name of Hal Holbrook. And he's like a, you know, an acting legend, like, you know, theater and Hollywood and all this type of shit. Yeah, they both was mad cool. Like, Gandolfini was mad cool. Turns out we're born on the same day, September 17th. Shout out to the Virgo crew.
Y'all almost made it.
No, we made it. We made it. that's the pinnacle. Anything else is, you know. But, yeah, it was a great experience.
Is there any kind of role that you haven't had that you, like, your dream role, like playing a cop or, like, a doctor?
Oh, man, see, that's what I'm saying. I'd like to, maybe, although I don't like to rep cop shit.
Right.
But, you know, they always give the cops some of the best roles. Like, you know what I mean? Like, as far as action and shit go. I'd like to do some action shit. Or maybe even, like, a lawyer.
I can see that.
No cheap suits.
No. Very expensive Thank suits. You. Tailored Thank suits.
I'd like to see you in the Luke Cage series.
Ah, yeah.
Marvel Entertainment.
Yeah.
Holler at Lord Jamar and let's have him in the Luke Cage series.
Yeah, I'd like to be maybe an evil villain too. Like,
No. Oh, okay. All right.
I don't mind being a bad guy.
Now, before you said about Oz Craft Services, I remember you were telling us how Sopranos has hands down the best craft services you've ever seen in your life.
Absolutely.
Did they handle the SAG, no SAG too over there? Or it was just straight up?
They Italian.
You know, I don't remember. Because some shows.
Be only SAG. Anyway.
Exactly. Everybody got to be SAG.
Yeah, like, you see, right, like, right,
see,
right,
see
right.
Oz had so many extras that it was like.
Oz might have been filmed with some charity, bro.
It would have been too much. It would have been too much money.
Oz
probably.
Might have been filmed with some Section 8 money, where you gotta have non-SAG,
right? For real.
But tell us why the Craft Services Sopranos was hands down the best ever.
I mean, it was just the level and the quality of everything that was there. Like they had real chefs and all that, and I've seen chef type shit on other sets as well. But it's like, again. This was just some next level shit. Like, you know what I mean? Like, and just the whole spread was just extra,
Forget about it.
Yeah. Like, trust me, you're going to find something that you like to eat in that motherfucker. Like, even if your diet, if you don't even fuck with whatever, you're going to find some bomb shit in there that was like, you know what I mean?
You know, it's funny because I feel like some of those guys that they...
Pastries and all
that. Really, cannolis.
All of that shit.
Lobster tails.
Yo, they might have had lobster shit like that. Seriously.
On
like,
Friday, they probably had lobster.
Yeah, I'm telling you, they had shit like that. And I don't eat lobster, but they had shit like that.
You never eat lobster?
Huh?
Are you allergic?
I don't eat crustaceans. Come on, that's the pig of the sea, man.
See, if I hung out with Lord Jamar, I would stop eating.
I thought
eating.
The lobster was the rat and the shrimp was the cockroaches. And
the same shit. Yeah, they are the cockroach. Same shit.
Right? Okay.
They are the janitors and they're not
so you've
really
you've never
human
tried it?
Oh, absolutely. When I was a kid, I used to love that
you
shit.
You was a 95% and you was down.
85.
Okay, I'm sorry. Sorry, I heard you.
Gotta leave the 15%. You know what? No.
When
that's
I was 85,
okay. 5, 85, and 10.
Okay, oh, we used to love to dip that lobster in that butter
and them blue crabs, brother.
Now next time,
blue crabs in the summertime.
Our crabs smell like shit.
Wait, what?
Crabs.
Not chitlins. I said crabs.
What about
crabs? Smell like
what
shit.
What about Cheddar Bay
They're
biscuits?
Not using the right beer.
Oh, Cheddar Bay biscuits, nice.
Listen, if you don't take some home with you,
Cheddar Bay biscuits, bro.
You ain't doing it right.
What, you got some here?
No. Yo, I want to go back. Like I said before, it's Organized Chaos. Brand Nubian. I just wanted you to give us a backstory on some songs that I feel are just like monumental.
Okay.
One for All.
One for All.
Anything like a backstory. Maybe something that somebody don't know, how it got created, anything, Maybe was it about to get scrapped? Who knows?
Well, the sample is a James Brown sample from an instrumental album that he did. And the way we sampled it was kind of not regular. It was like we took the front and put it in the back and took the back and put it in the front. So that's why if you play that record,
I'm talking.
You like that type of shit, don't you?
Flipping music over there.
You like the back and the front, yeah, and the front and the back.
I got the quiet storm voice.
Put the front in your back.
Oh, snap, snap, snap. You Supreme Ola, I'm about to give her that Ola.
Lil Jamar almost got that Frankie Crocker voice right there.
Okay.
Be easy.
Okay.
Be easy. Frankie Crocker, rest in peace.
What about Slow Down?
Slow Down, now, that was a record.
That's a true story.
We were having difficulty with. As far as, you know, sampling it and making it come fall right and all of that. We might have tried some different drums or some shit at
first. They got to come right.
And, yeah, the first session that we tried, it didn't really work. And so we put it down and came back to it. And then that next session is when, okay, yeah.
This I remember hearing Slow Down, and that was when I feel like crack had hit really hard. And I remember, like, the line, I think it's a dot, maybe. He said, we got a pair of my sneakers. Wonderberry got them because I hid them behind my speakers.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the crap, you know, like, yo, the way he was speaking all those lines in there, those words were so true because, you know, girl, guy, off that crack, you know, you lose your mind, you lose your life, you know? And that's what it's saying, slow down.
Yes, sir. Cautionary tale. You know, nowadays people tell you to speed up. Go ahead.
That's
do it.
Crazy children.
Turn down for
they
what?
They leaning, drooling, and
right.
Mumbling
turn down
on
for
the
what?
Tracks.
Why would you slow down? Slow down for what?
Mm-mm. I mean, another favorite of so many people, Punk Jump Up to Get Beat Down.
Mm. Yeah, well, Diamond D came to the table with that.
Like, shouts to Diamond
D. That whole album was self-produced except for that track.
Yeah.
And he came with a motherfucker.
Yeah, he did.
Matter of fact, he came with three different versions to that fucking song, and they all was monsters. Yeah.
Diamond D's a monster, man. Very underrated.
And we used all three versions, too.
Very underrated. Man, you put them all out. You know, is there one that a song that is your favorite as a Brand Nubian?
I don't know about one song, you know.
Or something that gives you the most
I'm
going to
tell you the best, I feel like the best Brand Nubian album is not the first one.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It's actually...
Just you and Sadat?
No, I say it's Foundation.
Okay.
To me, that's the best, like...
Why?
You know, sonic-wise and, you know, lyrics, production, everything to me on that record was really tight. And I'm good, thank you. It was a high level, you know. We were older, we knew a lot more, and just that was a really good one.
I asked
just wasn't
you when,
promoted right.
I asked you when we were in the green room, because I mean I can remember just Brand Nubian as. You know, just this incredible, influential group. And also coming out at a time when one of the only things you could be to be considered official by the fans was originality.
Mm.
Everyone had to have their own lane, their own style.
Mm-hmm.
Why has that value been erased from hip-hop? Why are people allowed to be formulaic?
Because someone sought to erase it. Because if it is formulaic, if you can create it in a way that's formulaic, now I can make I can make money off it easier, and I can duplicate the process with whoever I want, because it's a formula.
Speaking of formulas, what is the formula for maintaining the group? Or what is the biggest struggle you guys faced in your trio?
They faced a lot.
I think, you know, early on, our biggest struggle was just, you know, growing up. Just being young, you know. And you know, sometimes you butt heads and egos and all of that type of shit, you know.
When Pooba left, Mm-hmm. You know, did you? I know these guys had to push forward, but did you feel like giving up? No, I'm just saying there could be people who felt that way.
Not me. You know what I mean? Like, I'm that type of motherfucker, and he knows.
Big Mike.
Big Mike knows, okay? Because, you know, I just have a real competitive spirit. You know what I mean?
Yeah. No, I mean, I could tell.
And I have a real never say die attitude. Mm-mm. Like, I don't give a fuck. Like, if you beat me, I'm coming back. And I'm going to keep coming back until I fucking win. Period.
Talk about it.
You know what I mean? Like, that's just in my nature. Like, so, you know, a part of you is like, okay, you felt like you could do the shit. Well, now do it. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Did you even talk at that time, or you didn't see?
Nah, we wasn't really talking at that time. Yeah, he was just doing what he did. And
he just left, and
I mean, you know, you just shit gradually. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
things happen.
Yeah, I mean, if y'all got studio time and dude is not coming to the studio after a few times, it's kind of like, oh, yeah, all right, we got to do this.
All right, we might even have shows.
Nah, mostly I applaud you for that. Because the shows, you're right, you were talking about, I remember you telling me before that, you know, you would be at shows and he wouldn't show up. And people, even the promoters, were like, where's Pooh? You just grabbed Sadat, you and Sadat went up and did your thing and rocked out and moved on to the next one.
Mm-hmm.
And people really start to respect, like, look, this is you know, Brand Nubian, with or without Pooh.
Right.
But then, you know, even as strong-minded you are, you just made up, you know?
Absolutely.
How did that happen?
Time.
Time heals.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Time, like, you know. No, you know, first of all, negative energy is a hard energy to sustain.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, love is the energy that is infinite. Mm. But just think about sitting around trying to be mad at somebody, like, for a long extended time. Like, that's gonna fucking drain you, yo.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It's going to fucking drain you.
Instead of being out there giving love, receiving love.
Right, which energizes you.
Energize you, yeah. Yeah.
That's
so
true.
It's
that's
like,
true.
You know, after a while, it's like, you know, it gets to the point, like, what was this even about? Like, you know what I mean? And, you know.
Yeah, I think, you know.
It's a trans, you know, and it was, and it, what it was really about was just a transition, like, you know. Boys to men, like, he knew us, you know, we was the little homies.
Sure.
You know what I mean?
Right.
He's a little older than us.
Right.
So we was the little homies, and sometimes it's hard when your little homies become your peers.
And they level up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's kind of right at that moment when that happens, it's hard for you to accept that sometimes. And you might do shit to try to keep them at little homie level.
Right.
You know what I mean? But then, you know, and then also you got alpha males. You see what I'm saying? So when you got one alpha male and another alpha male, they're going to go at it. It doesn't have to be hatred. That's just how the fucking universe works.
Right.
Like, you know what I mean? Like, that's how shit just gets decided. Like, you know, and sometimes, you know. A lion got to, once the new alpha male come, the lion got to leave the pride.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And go start somewhere else. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And shit happens.
You were more vocal. You know, I mean, Sadat definitely had to be upset too, but he's more like, I feel like he was more quiet, you know?
I mean, you know, it's just the personalities. You know what I mean?
Hey, listen, I'm glad to see that, I mean, obviously it's been a minute since you guys, you know, reconciled, but even Dope too. I seen Pooh Bro a couple of years ago.
Mm-hmm.
He was supposed to do a show with us years ago. That never happened. But obviously people told me he just don't show. That's one of his MOs. But hey, I'm not knocking. I love everything Pooh Bro contributed to hip hop. But more importantly, when I seen him, he was like, man, swole and like big and like, you know, I was like, damn, but. You told me that he's lost a lot of weight and shit like that.
Recently,
so I'm glad to
recently,
hear that. Because, you know, honestly, actually, I want to take this moment real talk. And, you know, Q from World Star Hip Hop died
man,
today.
Rest in peace. Y'all heard about that. In his sleep type of shit.
Yeah. And
we can only assume that it had something to do
weight.
With his weight, yes. His diet.
Or was he overweight? Was he overweight?
He was a heavy set guy. Yes, he was definitely a heavy set guy.
Never seen him before.
And, you know, it's funny, too, because it's like you can say whatever you want about World Star. And I'm one that even makes fun of World Star. I felt at one point in time. I remember talking with Fab 530, and he was saying, like, look, one thing I don't like about World Star is that everything on there ain't hip-hop. Getting a blowjob in the back of a car doesn't make sense to me. You know what I mean? All that ratchet, stupid shit, he didn't like that. But he liked what he made. And I tell you, I like that. He was a young entrepreneur. That dude was self-made entrepreneur. Mm-hmm. And one thing I really loved is watching his Instagram over the years and his Twitter. Dude always spent time with his kids. That really, like, I like seeing somebody who's, made it like that, still making it, and then still spending the presents. Not only just, the gifts,
Presence over presence.
Most definitely. And I like that, dude. But anyway, the reason why I'm bringing that up for is because we spoke about weight. Like you're saying, even like, who's to know a lot of people are dealing with weight and then the sleep apnea. Am I saying it right?
No. Sleep apnea.
Okay, I'm sorry.
What app is it?
No, not on iTunes. The apnea, the machine.
Sleep apnea.
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 But it's, rest in peace to, and shout out to, the World Star Hip Hop family and me. His family, send blessings
absolutely.
His way.
Absolutely.
But, with Pooba, too, you can't, his weight is serious, man. Health is wealth. And unfortunately, we don't realize that until something happens.
Right.
I mean, look at Dallas. Dallas, almost this year with diabetes, almost lost his foot last year.
Wow.
Now all of a sudden, motherfucker's eating Brussels sprouts and kale and shit. Not because he wants to, because he's realizing, like, he told me one thing, too. My mindset is I'll run through the fucking wall. But your body later on, as you get older, catches up and say, go ahead, try. You ain't going to do that. And if you don't listen to your body after a while, things like that happen.
Mm-hmm.
So,
See, I've always been into, nutrition and, staying healthy, exercising and shit like that. So,
heard you.
But what's the routine? What's the exercise routine? Calisthenics,
push-ups.
Well, see, my natural metabolism is to be slim, too, so it's not like I have to do all of
he throwing the jitty shit.
No, good jeans.
I'm just saying, eat a lot, I'm just going to shit it out. That's what happens. I can't, bulk up.
You defecating
like
on the mic and the turtle.
But I don't eat bulky shit either. Like, you got to have portion control and shit like that. Like, not, I see people loading up their fucking plates. Like, damn, I can't, never could really eat like that.
Heavy hitters, man. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like, that's why I don't drink beer. Like, beer fills me up too much.
Yo, I'm about to give you dap and hugs. Like, yes.
Like, where's for real.
Beer? Come on.
Yeah.
Not heavy with the carbs either.
Are you into juicing?
I mean, I like it, but it's not something that I do all the time. I wish I was doing it more. Like, you understand what I'm saying? But, like for instance, I'm not into, eating dessert and shit like that. Mm-hmm. Like, by the time I finish my meal, I'm fucking full. Like,
right.
Mm-hmm. Who the fuck wants a fucking cake now? Like, that's some whole...
It's another
next greedy shit to me. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
if you was having cake, that should have been your meal.
Basically, and then who's going to have cake as a meal? Like,
I waited all my life
that's unhealthy.
To have cake as a meal, and now I got fucking diabetes.
Right.
The fuck?
Because you came into your adult life with a kid's mentality wanting to have cake as a fucking meal.
Yo, I am like, still come a child. On. I am.
He's Peter Pan, man.
He's got a
black Peter Pan.
He's got to mature. But do you ever feel like when you eat and you're full, but you still have room for ice cream? Or you still have room for dessert. You ever feel that way?
You got room for Jell-O. There's always room.
Really. Listen, I could be full as a motherfucker. Eat a steak. Eat a lobster.
I got room for a blunt.
Really? Mm. Okay. Mm. Okay. Shout out to all the
maybe a coffee
strains.
Black that's
coffee.
About it. I do after. That's about as much as I'll do after.
Yo, that's
a dinner.
How you, that's
is,
how you
is
shit
a coffee.
It out. Internet.
Cafe Bustelo. You've eaten Latin? No.
Well, my people's from French Guyana.
Listen, you know what I wanted to ask you. You're always on Vlad TV.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking 19, 20, 30 times a fucking month. Right? Dude,
because I'm that guy.
No, but hold on. Do you think that Vlad, how people are coming at him saying that, he appropriates, and is like, he's trying to just get people for, information.
That he's a culture vulture.
Culture vulture, yeah.
Thank you.
Do you believe in that?
Thank you for that.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Any, like I said from the beginning, like, this hip-hop shit is some black shit.
Yeah.
Let's make no mistake about it.
Now, is that the reason why you said that Eminem would never go down as one of the greats?
No, I just don't like Eminem. Like,
what? As a person or as a rapper?
As a rapper.
Because you just feel like he's like a dictionary rapper? No song.
He's just corny to
me. All like these big words, like repetitiously.
Just corny.
Gotcha.
You don't like Renegade? You don't like Renegade? M&JC?
No.
What?
And that's the one that a lot of people try to point out. Oh, he roasted Jay-Z.
Well, what about
I don't think so.
What about
don't you feel like Eminem really has Redman's content, but he's allowed to get rich off Redman's content because
he takes it even crazier than Redman would take it, though. Like, with some of the shit he says. He says shit that Redman would never say.
Like killing his mother.
Because Redman,
all that dumb shit.
But like, white man, you know,
white
say
people
that.
Curse their mother out.
Yeah, that shit.
Right? Yeah, but
killed his mother every album.
But keep
and
in mind,
him.
Keep in mind, to each is their own, though. Like, what you would rap about, somebody else wouldn't rap about.
Right.
You know,
so that's
like,
what I'm saying.
Everybody grew up different.
If you want Eminem to be in your top such and such, fine. He's not in mine.
Who is in yours?
He's not even in my. And I keep telling people, and they say, what? When I say this, they go crazy.
What about Action Bronson?
He's not even in my top 50.
What about Action Bronson?
Wait,
how
what?
Do you say that? How do you say he's not in your top 50?
Drop mic. Done. Mm-hmm. And this interview has been concluded.
How do you? Okay, listen. That, to each is their own. What about Action Bronson?
What about him?
No, I'm saying, what about somebody like him? He's different.
He rhymes about some crazy shit, too. You know who I like?
Okay.
Vinny Paz.
Vinny Paz? Mm.
I think that's his artist. That's your
Vinny
artist?
I just know he likes Vinny Paz.
He's stuck plugging
Vinny
your
Paz
artist.
Is no,
you don't like Vinny Staples. What about
Vinny? My favorite white MC.
Really?
Okay. Because he don't rhyme about dumb
what
shit.
What about the Asian kid, Rich Chigga? You like him?
Never heard of him.
Okay.
But you did say that white rappers were guests in hip-hop?
Absolutely. And all the real white rappers will tell you, absolutely, they're guests. Mm. I know Apathy, dudes like that. They fuck with me. They know that's real
shit. You don't
think
what Macklemore did years ago, where he apologized, was corny?
Where he apologized?
You don't remember where he apologized?
When he
because
got the award
he got
over
the award
Kendrick?
Over Kendrick, and he apologized.
I think it was a Grammy.
Yeah, that was corny.
Because people know... People know what, you know, what privilege is, you know? He knows what his privilege is. I mean, but him admitting...
He made a song called White
Privilege. White Privilege, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Speaking of white rappers, how you feel about Kanye now that he's Kardashian?
What do you mean, speaking of white rappers?
He's a Kardashian now.
Yeah, he's a white rapper.
He's different now. He's not the same.
He got the blonde
Jesus
hair
walking.
And everything,
yeah,
right?
He ain't walking with Jesus no more. He walking a little lower and a little lower.
You know when I knew that something was really, really wrong with Kanye? When he had those eyes. You see those fucking eyes he was wearing at that fashion show?
Oh, contact? Yeah.
I was like, what
that.
The fuck? Dude, yo, Ritalin.
But how do you feel about, I know you were saying that he was one of the kids, but how do you feel about his transition and even him meeting with Trump and all of those things, like having the outburst against Jay?
I think he's bugging. You know what I mean? I think the boy hasn't been mentally right since his mama passed, rest in peace, to Donda West. I think she was a stabilizing force in his life, you know? I think she was the one that fucking didn't yes
kept
man
him
to
right.
death and
kept him grounded.
Would have smacked the shit. You ain't marrying that girl.
Yeah.
That girl a hoe.
Get that blonde.
That girl hair. Got a goddamn porno on a goddamn internet. Nigga, get over here. Is what the fuck she would have said if she was alive.
Fuck you wearing that blonde hair.
Now you can get that pussy, but nigga, you better get your ass back old. Get your ass back home. What the hell, you I ain't gonna be my goddamn gonna have no porno girl as my damn daughter-in-law. Is what the fuck I think she would have said. Now without that stabilizing factor, you know, this motherfucker's just on some.
But he's continuing.
Damn, that makes me sad because I love 808s and Heartbreak.
Yeah, but that was all. That was
I don't.
I'm Travis Scott.
That's the beginning of the whack to me.
That's when Travis Scott
but
started.
I mean,
writing
that was when
him.
He was, you know,
he was hurting. He was hurting.
That was his album in mourning.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you knew it effed him up though.
That's the album that where he started diverging from the Kanye that pulled us in.
You right. ever had run-ins with him or just chopped it up with him or
nah.
nothing?
No. Nah.
What about the Beastie Boys? You ever had toured with them? Who'd you tour with when you toured back then?
I toured with a lot of people.
No, I know, but mainly a lot, like where you were with a lot.
Now, only now do they box you into a group. Back then, well, you first toured with everybody.
Well, at first you might start touring with people on your label. You know what I mean?
Okay.
So we was like us, leaders.
Okay.
KMD.
No.
Destruction.
I feel like I had to see that show. KMD was doomed.
Well, yeah, exactly. But it was funny because, you know, when they started the tour, you know, they was on there like Ansar Rule shit at the time.
Oh,
so they
really?
Were wearing like white robes and shit like
that.
White kufis and shit on stage.
See, I thought they was more native tongue. Like, nah, they was more, that was hard.
They was on like the, you know, like those Muslim, like the oil selling type you know, Dr. York type of shit. So I remember, but they looked up to us. You know what I mean? They was looking up to Brand Nubian and the gods, and you know that they like that type of shit. So,
doing some Africa. I remember.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So I remember at the beginning of the tour, you know, they had the white robes and they're performing like this, you know. But then they seeing how we moving, like we ain't wearing no robes. We wearing, you know what I mean? Low, all kind of shit. We smoking weed, we getting high, we doing it, you know what I mean? We fucking with bras, we doing it all, you know what I mean? And we killing these shows, you know what I mean? By the time fucking this tour ends, the motherfuckers took them robes off. They start drinking wine on the bus. Like, that was they letting their hair down. They didn't start smoking weed, but they start drinking wine and shit. And and it helped them, actually. It helped their stage presence and all that, because people was looking at them like, who's the guys with the white robes on? Like,
what's up with that?
You know, they look a little too righteous to be even performing right now. Like, you know, so that loosened them up. And now look at Doom.
Forget him.
He loosed in a motherfucker now.
Loose than a goose.
See him.
Hell yeah.
Yo, everybody, every group has it. We need to know the level. Brand Nubian groupies. 1 to 10. How were the Brand Nubian groupies?
Back in the days, they were great.
Okay. I
mean, they're still good.
10.
10, really?
Yeah, it was great.
See, for you to give it back, you know.
They're still good. They're just a little more mature now.
Okay.
Who's more mature? The hoes?
No, Brand Nubian group.
We're not dealing with that. We're grown men now. We're
the elder thoughts
and all of that type of stuff.
Sure.
But
escorts.
But when we was young.
But it's sometimes I guess maybe I relate sometimes to sex too much. But sometimes you have like crazy things that realize some of your either fame or things you have done that you know. Because think about it. Because you're Brand Nubian. I mean, even though you were probably bagging girls way before then, obviously.
Absolutely.
But because,
and that's the difference between some people and the others.
Yeah,
like, some people get into
you.
This game and they never had bras
before,
and this is all new to them. Me and my, we Ben was getting bras.
But back then, like.
And I'm not talking about Brand Nubian, I'm talking about me and my dudes.
And the block.
Jamar. Yeah, the ones that I used to run
DJ KD.
Yeah.
We Ben
and the M11-3.
But think about it. Sometimes some of these groupie stories, man, crazy. Crazy. Meaning, like, where people, you know, just because you're Brand Nubian, don't want to go backstage, anything, you know?
Absolutely. I mean, you know.
Yeah, you know.
I'm not, without getting into specifics, I could say that I've had nights that's like.
Threesomes?
Like,
foursomes?
Anybody die?
With like 10 girls lined up outside my door waiting.
Really?
Let's just say that.
Mm. Fuck.
Damn, we should have been friends back then, man. I would have you don't got this one? I got this one. Don't worry, you got like 8 here.
Nah, it was too crazy that night. Everybody had their hands full, but I.
You finished that line?
I really had my hands full. Yeah, it
good
was
customer
crazy.
Service means everything.
It was crazy.
But you know what? Before we miss out on where we started, you said Vlad, and I know you do a lot of things with him.
Yeah, okay, yeah, go by. Oh, okay.
Because I don't want to leave it at just that.
Yeah, let's not just leave it at that. Is he a culture vulture? Yes. Okay? Are there worse culture vultures out there? Yes. I feel like he's a culture vulture with a conscience.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Like, he doesn't have... If you want to just suck from our culture, he doesn't have to have people like me out there. with my alternative. Like, I'm just shaking up the whole shit. He's getting people like Polite on there. You understand what I'm saying? He's trying to get the Dr. Umar Johnsons and the, you know what I mean? He's striving to do what some black people, I mean, rest in peace to my man Q, but he ain't ever got invited to do an interview on World Star, and I'm not sure how much, you know,
World Star's never captured any content.
Positive stuff is on there, but you know, is he a culture vulture in the sense that, okay, Vlad is Russian, right?
What?
Okay, and his name is not Vladimir; it's Vladislav.
His name is Boris.
Okay, now, Vlad. His website is, if it was based on Russian culture,
what are you saying? If he had dot,
it wouldn't be popping.
Okay.
What I'm saying is, if all his videos were Russian music, Russian interviews, who the fuck wants to see that?
Yeah.
Except just Russians.
Yeah, the only good Russian videos are the ones where the guys walk in front of the train by accident.
That's not nice.
Do you understand what I'm saying? So this is why people are called culture vultures, because they're coming in from an outside culture, because their culture is not popping enough for them to do what they're doing with this hip-hop shit. Mm. Yeah. Okay.
Not really true either, though. But yes. But
what do you
mean
not really true?
Oh, well, I mean Moscow has their own Hollywood.
In Moscow. I'm talking about here in America.
Yes, sir.
If Vlad TV's content was strictly devoted to some Russian shit, he would not be making as much money. We probably would not even know who the fuck he was.
Only
Russian people would know about him.
Even in this upcoming political administration?
Yes. Tell me where Russian culture is popping right now in America.
Brighton Beach.
Right.
Okay.
Only in Brighton Beach. Vodka and means. I've been to Tatiana's. You ever been to Tatiana's?
Yes.
Great food. Hold up. They put on a great fucking show.
Amazing.
But who fucking knows about
that? Did you eat the borscht?
Huh?
No, you know borscht, the soup.
Tatiana's
bush.
You know what I love about?
No, I feel like Russian is more.
That's a word he actually said right this time.
On the New Jersey Turnpike at the rest stops, the people working in the rest stop,
they just sidebar,
are mostly Russian.
No,
so I feel like there's a lot of Russians in Jersey right now.
Yes, there's a lot of Russians in Staten Island. What I'm saying is Russian culture is not popular culture. Black American culture is.
But there are still some people that were
popular around the world.
That's not alternative facts. That's facts.
Yeah, but I want to give you a fact. You never hardly see a homeless Russian person.
Right.
I'm going to tell you, you very, very rarely see a homeless Russian person. I know a lot of Russians for many years, and to see one, they look down on that totally crazy. And I'm going to tell you one thing I respect about the Russians, they'll have a regular job, like me and you, but they'll have like a fucking X600, S500 Benz, and you're like, how the fuck did you get that? Because something ain't right.
I'm not talking against Russians.
No, I'm not
stating a fact that the reason why people are called culture vultures is because, especially when you're white and you come in and you fuck with black music, black media, whatever the case may be, you're doing it because your culture's not popping. Mm-hmm. Not even just Russian culture. Like, give me some shit that's real. You see what I'm saying? With the
Thai
same
food.
Huh?
Chinese food.
Korean food.
I'm not talking about food.
All right, I'm sorry. But back to what I was saying, there are some people that would say that what you're saying is true, but Vlad is not putting you on his site to push the culture forward. He's putting you on his site because he knows that you're going to say some shit to get him views. Like, he's not thinking about,
what I'm saying.
Is this going to cause conversation?
That's the difference, is that me knowing him, I know that it's both.
Okay.
He's definitely about that paper. He's definitely wants the comment. He wants them clicks. But I believe he really does, like, love this hip-hop shit, even though he's you know, he's a little confused too, though, with his some of his observations on this shit. But what I'm saying is, if he was such a scumbag, mm-hmm. right, he could make his money without having any of these, you know.
Without even having you in the discussion.
Exactly. Why have me on there then? Why bring Polite on? Why bring, is it just for the views? I could bring other shit. I could have a girl sitting there with her titties out fucking masturbating and get views. Why not do that?
Right.
Sure.
Right.
Mm-hmm. The World Star had an X-rated version, you know, where for the real raunchy videos, yeah, you got to go into the Triple X World Star, right?
Yeah. They had a Triple X World Star?
No, they had a like a thing with girls. I forgot the section name of it.
Some shit like that. Yeah.
Pussy
like,
Star, some shit.
Yeah. Vlad ain't got no shit like that. Like, and I'm, you know, I'm not trying to put my man down, but I'm just saying, like, and I'm, and at the same time, I'm not trying to be a Vlad cheerleader either. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like,
I'm sure
all these motherfuckers is the label is a culture vulture. Mm. Mm. We signed with a label, Elektra Records. They were culture vulturing us. But sometimes, like you said, you take that bag from the Hennessy people or whatever, and you do good works.
Mm-hmm. Right,
you
rich,
see?
The
so it's like you could talk all this culture vulture shit all you want, but you know, the things I've been saying, you know, over the past few years on Vlad have actually permeated into the consciousness of the population, and I've been a good voice for the alternative of what they're trying to
right, like a counteraction.
Push on you, and I'm also the voice for original hip hop. You know mm-hmm. what I mean? Like, I'm a curator in a way.
Lil
you know
Jamar,
what I mean?
Lil Jamar,
who decides what gets into a museum? The curator,
yes,
right?
Indeed.
Who decides if it's authentic? They examine it, they look at it. That's not a real fucking Picasso. You don't get in, bitch.
And it's more than that. The curator doesn't just authenticate, the curator also says, this must be viewed by the public. This is what the public
needs
receive.
To see.
Yes, yes. Lord Jamar, you said that you were the alternative, and I just wanted to remind you that we are no longer allowed to use the word alternative. As black folk, alternative has been hijacked by white folk right now. They have alternative facts.
Right.
You know, where slavery well, was not that bad. They have alternative right wing.
Right.
Which is,
oh,
and
that's
they
crazy.
A new name for the Ku
white supremacists.
Yes.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
they
yeah.
also have alternative music.
Again,
except Michelle,
and they have alternative, you know, gender.
How do you feel about that alternative music?
Cosette Michelle,
mm-hmm. and that performance.
I didn't even see it. I know
nor
she
did
performed.
I.
You know, she got it paper.
Was, did you feel
listen,
like that was a good move?
She took from Hennessy to do good.
I
you
mean,
believe in that? Listen, she got the bag. Let her.
Yeah, she got
let her do
bag.
Good work.
I don't hate her for it. Mm-hmm. Like you know, mm-hmm.
You just hope she's doing good works with it.
Absolutely. Right. Like, I, you know, she
is
probably could have used
the bag. Is
there
any amount of money that could have made you perform?
No. See, I'm not into all of this politics shit. You
right.
know what I mean? And
so
there's certain
like, listen,
symbols.
Go get him. I got $5 million on it. You
see, there's certain symbols. There's certain symbols that, like, they would be so strong that money.
It's not worth it.
Yeah. Mm. Like the way it's $5 million. Let's just
That's
say
heavy.
You got $5 million. But just the. For generations to come, they can use like Lord Jamar's image to say. Whatever the fuck.
Right.
Like.
The balance.
Yeah, like he just totally flipped. Like, so all that black shit, I don't believe that shit. This guy who was a champion of that shit, he fucking,
right.
he mm-hmm. flipped. You know what I mean? Like, I just, again, I don't have to worry about it. They're not going to ask me.
And it's, it's over. It's anyway. Over. It's over for now. They're
yeah,
not gonna
yeah, because yeah. you say he's going to be in office for 10 years. I'm trying no, to figure no, out the roster. Y'all done adding more years.
No, no, I'm just saying.
The most that it could be is
people no, they should, add, no, people they should put a 10-year plan together. A 10-year plan together in the sense that, you know, the previous presidential administration we were living through was not really focused on, you know, your needs or your equity anyhow. You know, but then, you know, I don't want to be the guy in here saying bad about Obama. Obama was the greatest president we ever had.
He was definitely the coolest, definitely the most.
He had the most swag. Most,
yeah, but sure. definitely somebody who, you know, was a class act, I think. You know, you can say whatever you want about, you know, I don't really follow politics either, so I don't know what he did, but he was a class act. But you know what? Before we close out the episode and a couple last things, let's get into I Don't Trust People. Lord Jamar, what we have is a segment called I Don't Trust People. It's where we, you know, basically have people who submit, you know, things they don't trust, what they don't trust. You know how to get involved. Internet, use the hashtag I Don't Trust People. That's I Don't Trust PPL on Twitter, at Premium Pete, at Premium Pete Show, Miss Listen Knows, Dallas Penn. Let us know who or what you don't trust. What do we got this week?
Our first submission comes from Dig Set. I don't trust people that rock Tim's without the leather upper. That's the brim. Okay.
Naked Tim?
But if you're putting your jean over it, why does it matter?
Well,
like, who's seeing this? Dallas, is it cheaper to get those? Maybe they don't like that part of the gal.
You know what? Your clothing does not make you authentic. All right? You make your clothing authentic. The person wearing it. Naked Tim's, listen, Tim's sandals. Whatever your...
Not thong sandals.
The ones between the toe.
Get the fuck out of here. I'm not fucking with
you. Okay, you know what I was taught?
You got one?
I got one.
Okay.
Because I was told this. Okay. I was taught this okay. a long okay, time good, ago. Let's
talk to us.
I was told, never trust a man that has a beard and no mustache. This is what I was told.
That's a true fact.
A beard and no never, mustache.
You know those motherfuckers with the beard and no mustache. Yeah, it'd be all looking like
Julio.
One of those old time motherfuckers from back in the 1700s type mother Amish looking motherfuckers. Them motherfuckers. Don't you trust them.
You have to
They're connect. Missing an essential.
You gotta have that connection right there. Because now it's like
satellites. You're just going around the orbit. You're not connected.
And it's almost like
your Wi-Fi.
But what if the beard?
You haven't fully. What if the beard committed? You haven't made a full decision. You don't know if you want a clean face or do you want hair on your face.
Yeah.
Don't trust those people.
What if the beard on the chin though is at least fully formed?
What if
they could have had some kind of psoriasis on the lip and can't grow a mustache?
Listen, well, that's a
maybe the beard is a the representation. Special,
we'll give him a pass. We'll
they
give him a pass.
That's
a
special all of that, then. No.
thing. And still,
okay.
just go for still, the clean shave.
All I'm saying is you still got to watch.
You got to look.
Okay.
No,
okay.
You still got
to
watch.
You got to look. You got to star in a Tyler Perry
This is
movie.
What I was taught.
Okay. I dig
funny
that,
that you
dig
even
that.
Have a segment, but this is what I was taught. years ago, I was taught this.
Dig
I mean,
that.
As a child.
Well, our next one is from Ray Fernandez, M.A. I don't trust people that eat chunky applesauce or use chunky peanut butter. You're a hater.
Well, I don't like chunky applesauce.
I don't know about chunky applesauce. That's
I like
not
chunky,
sauce.
Chunky peanut,
That's apples.
Peanut butter. You know, it's funny because I got to tell the story. When I was away, I was skinny. And I mean, I'm still skinny, but I wanted to gain weight. So somebody had told me, like, yo, eat peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, man. Eat them as much as you can. So I had got, in commissary, I had bought a loaf of bread and peanut butter. Let me tell you something. I was eating like 12, 13, 14 a day. Because they said that peanut butter stick to your stomach. They stick to your, whatever they said. Sticks to
your
something.
Your ribs.
Your ribs. Thank you. And all of a sudden, I did it for like three weeks straight, I ate fucking 13, 14 peanut butter jelly sandwiches a day. At the end, I think I counted up was like 300 fucking sandwiches.
And what happened?
I went on the scale, and I gained 1 pound. I wanted to fucking jump off the fucking top of the fucking jail. But anyway, you know, I still love peanut butter.
Shout out to Fidel Fresco, our honorary team member. Mm-hmm. I don't trust people that talk on speakerphones in the street.
I hate people like that, honestly.
Stop being a hater.
Yo, real talk. No, I hate people like that.
I'm booked, my nigga. My hand's full. I got to make this phone call. It's important.
First of all, I don't like being the person on the phone with somebody who has me on speaker like that because you can never hear them well enough.
I just don't trust people that don't announce that you're on speakerphone. Like, you got to let me know because I might start talking about your little sister friend, the one with the gimp leg, and she right there like, oh, what? I'm like, nah, don't bring her around. I don't like that one.
I got another one.
Yeah, and you got that good Quiet Storm voice.
I just came up with it. Never trust a motherfucker that wear dress shoes with tube socks.
Word to mother.
I'm just saying.
Oh, that's fucked up.
White
that's
tube socks.
Up. That's
white fu- tube white socks.
That's fucked up. I don't wear dress.
They probably
going to
kill
socks.
Somebody at some point.
That's a fact.
We got anybody else?
Our last one comes from Mike Droppers. I don't trust people who blow their blessings to rep in the streets. When you're out, stay out.
What?
Like, if you are doing well and being, you picked it. Don't look at me like I'm bugging. So what I'm taking from this is when you're doing well, instead of you doing well and just continuously doing that, you go back to your street life. You try to still do things that are, you know, a disservice to your grind.
Gotcha.
And then, well, this was you think.
Well, first of all, sometimes, to be honest with you, people don't know. When you live that street life, you know, it's funny because it's like slow money is sure money. But sometimes it's hard once you live a certain type of life. That's why I don't judge. Anybody could do it. To each is their own, you know. And I think we spoke about a lot of this episode. Like what Jamar said. Like basically, to each is their own. A lot of how people feel about certain things.
How you view it, what your perspective.
Word to mother. But you know, for me, you know, I'll say it's not easy. Like, I came home. I stayed home. You know, I've been home a minute, man, almost 14 years. But real talk, it ain't that easy. You know, it ain't that. And I know what it is when you live a certain life. But if you want to stay home, you have to sacrifice. You have to have patience. You know, I'll give an example. When I just came home 14 years ago, the parole officer came and she said, look, you got a 9 o'clock curfew. All the people I came with, wait till they came. And they left and they went outside. They were waiting outside, busted them, brought them back. You know, me? I rented every fucking DVD it was. Every DVD I rented. Every DVD. And I just stayed in-house, and I got off early. But the point I'm making is I had to sacrifice.
Sacrifice.
So, mm-hmm. You know.
Anyway. Well, you also had money to rent DVDs.
Well, hey, listen.
What if you didn't have money to rent DVDs?
I was hustling. Well, shit, then you fucking watch TV at mom's house, wherever you parole to.
Oh, you know, he did what he was doing, like, and when he was in
I didn't only rent DVDs. I jerked off every fucking night. What the fuck?
See?
Anyway, listen, you spoke about an artist. Do you have a label, or is there other artists you're working with?
Well, I'm managing this artist, Aaron Cooks. He signed a conglomerate.
Where's he from? Busta Rhymes label.
Absolutely.
Shout out to Shaheem Reed.
No doubt. He's from Syracuse, New York.
Nice.
Okay, so, yes, real hip-hop is going to be coming from New York. But ain't nobody said it had to be from downstate. These motherfuckers, my man, telling you, he's one of the nicest kids I've heard.
How did you discover him?
Internets, interwebs, you know.
You can say internets. You can say it. I don't get paid nothing.
We got to fix that.
No, that's
get
all right.
Get your chicken.
Somebody just sent me his music one day, and I thought it was something else, and I just happened to listen. And
that's dope.
Nice.
I couldn't believe that he wasn't signed or nobody was fucking with him, and he, you know.
Oh.
So I made it my duty to.
And let's check him out. What's his name again?
Aaron Cooks.
I have a question for the Lord. What did you learn in your journey and everything that you've been through and been still doing? Like, what have you learned?
What have I learned?
Yeah, like. Just the ins and outs, like, everybody ain't shit, like, anything, like, any gem, like, just, like, damn, I didn't know that would happen, and now it's, like, the biggest lesson.
Biggest lesson is that, you know, you, that everything is okay at all times, that you know, you really are God. That's the biggest lesson, like, you know, that I was always right. That's my biggest lesson. I always was right.
You mean that you're your own God? You mean like?
No, that God
lives.
I mean, you're your own God, yes, but then yes, God is within you and it's within all of us, and everything you see is actually just small divisions of the whole.
Mm.
You know, and the whole is just experiencing himself through his creations.
Mm.
You understand what I'm saying? And this is not no religion shit I'm talking right now. This is just
spirituality.
Yeah, this is just and reality.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Whether it's real or not, this is the reality of our existence.
Yeah. No, I like that.
So, yeah.
What about acting? Any new things that we'll see you in?
Last thing I did was The Night Of.
Mm-hmm. I love that show.
Yeah, that was a great I'm glad to, you know, have been a part of that. I don't have anything in the works as of yet. But,
okay, but things are percolating.
Yeah, should always
things are percolating. You're touring.
Yeah. Well,
and Poop is touring too, you said, were you, right?
Yeah, he been touring with us. You're making it sound like...
I don't remember.
Yeah, we've been doing...
Okay, well, listen, I'm glad to see Brand Nubian and not... what was it? The other one? That you're gonna call?
Nubian Force.
Nubian Force.
Well, the Nubian Force.
Imagine they said this. One for all. Nubian Force. Is all for one. Anyway, listen. I appreciate you stopping by. It's always great to just chop it up with someone who, to me, I always love people who are diversified. I always say that found the lane and then created another lane. It's springboard, man. It's inspiring that.
Well, I've got other lanes too.
No, of course.
Now I'm a producer as well.
Okay.
Also did voiceover for ESPN for like 5 years.
Really? On what?
For the X Games.
Oh, really?
Yeah, a lot of people didn't know that. So that's where I learned. We was talking about skiing.
Yeah, okay,
right?
Okay,
that's
okay.
That's where
yeah.
I learned to fucking ski in Aspen and shit.
Look at
like
you,
that.
Look at you.
Fucking with these.
Get your white people on.
Exactly.
I like that.
But not full.
No, not full pace.
White people.
Not full pace.
You know, because these motherfuckers, they go in the jacuzzi in the cold,
what?
Outside in the middle of the night. Oh, hell motherfucking no.
No. Even if the baddest bitch was coming in that
jacuzzi. They were in there.
What?
I didn't do it.
The snow bunnies.
I didn't do it. You want to get... I'm good.
Mm-mm.
Thank you, but no
but
thank you.
You still got to get out, and you're going to be freezing.
Exactly. You got to get in and got to get out.
Hello.
Yeah. I'm not with it.
Mm-mm.
And when you get out, that's the problem.
Testicles got frostbite. You good.
Shit.
Well, it's a hot tub, so it shouldn't.
No, but when you get out, it's not a hot tub anymore. Now you walk in.
But if you get out and then get back in, that shit feels so good.
Nah, see, that's some polar bear shit. Yeah, that I'm not with.
Like the they have that in Coney Island every year where people.
Exactly. Not too many black people running.
No,
in
no, world. No. Actually, Dallas did that. Dallas did the polar bear. One year, yeah, he did the polar bear 1 year. Was it that cold when you jumped
in? Why in the hell would you do that?
Nah, it wasn't that cold when I jumped in because it was a warm New Year's Day. Like it was like the temp was like 50 degrees.
Wow. So but how'd the water feel?
Thought the water was going to be 50 degrees.
More like
the water was still freezing.
But why'd you do that? Just because that was?
I did it because I mean, you see mad people do it. Mad Russians in Brighton Beach. So I said, let me do a lot of New York City stuff. Like, people in the city, you're a city kid, even still growing up in New Rochelle, but you think you've done everything once you've gotten on a train or you've been in the city. You haven't done everything. There's tons of things to do. And getting in the water New Year's Day was one of them. Will I ever do it again? No.
They say that it
that was never on my bucket list.
Me either. They say it wakes people up. Like, it gives you, like, this shock. Did it do that shit to you?
It's stupid. Yeah.
Honestly, the best thing I've seen as we end off, the best thing I've seen was that little Chinese kid on the internet with a sign that said, "I love naps, but I stay woke."
Mm.
You seen that?
I did see that.
You saw that? Okay.
I did not.
Okay.
Did
well, shout it. Out to whoever made that sign and put it on that young Ming Lee. But, anyway, internet, Lord Jamar, make sure you check from. Look back to some of this shit, too. Look back to Oz. Oz is available, right? You know?
Yeah.
Look back to check
DVD
if you've never seen
it. All that type
right,
of
look
shit.
Look back at it.
Yeah, you know? And listen, anyway, we wish you the best. We hope for more gigs. Yeah. Shout out to ESPN.
Follow me at Lord Jamar.
What about on Instagram?
Yes, all the same Lord shit. Lord Jamar, okay.
On all social media channels.
Yeah, follow my man Aaron Cooks too, at God Cooks on all social media. God Cooks.
That's a bet. That's a bet. Aaron Cooks. And listen, internet's one for all. Brand Nubian.
Yes, sir.
Not Nubian Force.
Although the Nauru mob ended up being, you know.
Okay.
Just our people.
Yeah. Part of the posse. Yeah.
Yeah, but I think that was a name. I got one kid who's like a fucking Brand Nubian historian. Like, he was around and his fucking, you know, he didn't smoke weed. And, like, his memory is so fucking good at that time. I bet you he knows all the fucking names.
Yeah, we need to get him next time. When you come back, you bring him with you.
He knows all the fucking names. Definitely bring him with you.
When you come back. So, we, you know, give the Brand Nubian fans just listen to his event.
Dope. Yeah, a great time in hip-hop. A great time for hip-hop.
Most definitely. Down. But anyway, listen, internets, make sure you subscribe. SoundCloud, Google Play, Stitcher, whatever the fuck, all the podcasting platforms. Make sure you subscribe, rate, tell a friend.
Or wait, because we have a website. We have a Nucleus umbrella situation where you could get everything done. You go to thepremiumpshow.com.
There you go.
Just get everything.
But who goes to websites anymore?
Get your lives. We want hits.
Yeah, you know, you don't need a website. You need an app.
You over here go to Stitcher, bitch at your mom's house, ask your aunt, turn to your neighbor, premiumpshow.com.
It's not getting crazy now.
Hello.
There you go.
Make it easy for the
internet. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Dallas Penn, Miss Listen Knows. Mr. Motherfucking Lord Jamar.
Yes.
The Lord is in the building.
See you next episode.